Start streaming. All right, let's see. I'm going to do this in YouTube only, and I think it's going to work. So we're going to make a different chat window so we can see what's up with chat. And move that over there. So today, it's a rainy day in Rochester, New York, a rainy night. It is 10:32 p.m. and I've been working on rabbit holes. So I wanted to share the pain. If you think you've been working on a rabbit hole, I bet my rabbit holes are bigger than your rabbit holes. So let's see if that's true. You can tell me about your rabbit holes that you've been working on, and we'll take a look at these waste of time boards that are highly unlikely to be fixed. Let's see if I can make chat pop out. All right, so let's see. This is Drew from class, says Crazy Face McGee. What up, Drew? Drew fixed something today. Drew had some good ideas that he then proceeded to convince everybody were bad ideas. That was pretty funny to watch. All right, let's see. Pop out chat. All right, so we'll put chat over there, minus this, and holy dead bug. Yes, so this one here is in the no fix pile. So this is here for data. It's a 6+, and it started out having a short on the 1V8 line. So 1V8 short, I went around and looked for the short and decided that it was likely under the NAND, which it was. So I took the NAND off and thought, hey, cool, there is no short on the board. And the NAND was really weird underneath. It had like no underfill in sections of it. And every now and then I've seen a short under the NAND. So I thought, hey, this is great. So I tested the NAND, and the NAND did not have an internal short. So there was something about the connection between the NAND and the board, I thought, that was creating this 1V8 short. So what I did, because the NAND was so janky, I did this dead bug NAND thing. So this is the second time I've done this for this same exact repair. And I made jumpers for every single one of these NAND pads on the chip to the board. And I tested in diode mode and I checked, and every single thing had the right diode mode resistance. So I said, let's fire it up, because I wanted to get an answer. And the second that I fired it up, boom, it grew back a 1V8 NAND, a 1V8 line short. What? So I thought it would obviously have to do with one of these jumpers, so I started taking them off one by one to see what would make my NAND, my 1V8 short go away. And guess what I found out? Took them all off, and I still had a 1V8 short on the board. Well, I didn't start out with a 1V8 short on the board after I had removed NAND. So I looked around and I found a bad cap. Kicked that cap off, and 1V8 short goes away. So today, while the students were solving the sex toy mini, the weekly sex toy mini at Practical Board Repair School, I put all these 60 jumpers back on and finally got to fire it up. And guess what? It showed the Apple logo. Yay! And it started to look like it was going to boot, and then it immediately went to recovery mode. And I kicked it out of recovery. It goes back into recovery mode. And so I hit update, and it fails with error 9. So this thing is, that's it for me on that one. I have put back everything. Everything has a normal diode mode resistance. And when I plug it in, I can see that Apple logo and I can hear it detect. And it's in recovery mode and it fails with error 9. So that is almost certainly, in this case, going to be just a bad, straight up bad NAND. So nothing you can do. Data recovery, bad NAND. That goes to the not recoverable, $0, giant waste of time. Fuck you. All right, so let's stick that over there and never look at it again. Great, moving on. So while we're looking at rabbit holes, if you thought that was bad, hey, take a look at this board that originally I had completely declined. And then the guy begged and pleaded, so I said, fine. So I'm about to waste more time on this beautiful iPhone 5 that apparently has already been around the world to a whole bunch of different people. And yes, I do have the NAND offboard flex strips, but this one had some damage to the NAND and to the pads. That's why I had to do those jumpers. So, all right. So let's see. Let's move this over here and move this over here so that I can see everything. Let's move this over here. All right. So there we go. All right. After class instruction, I guess. All right. A Lewis project. What? Lewis would never in a million years. All right. I've been having regular nightmares of AI taking over humanity. That sounds like just a bad dream. Time to reprogram NAND. You can't reprogram the NAND and get data. That kind of reformats the NAND, so there's no path to data. All right. Is this the fuck no hell no board? Yes, it is. Yes, it is. All right. So let's take a look at this iPhone 5 and see why I think this rabbit hole is bigger than your rabbit hole. So let's see. You guys that are working on whatever rabbit holes around the world, I hope you can listen to this stream and feel a little bit better about your project, because at least it's not this board. So I've looked at this board before, and let's take a look and see what's up with it. Well, here's a random dude just hanging out for no reason. All right, so let's see. The butt got a bunch of water damage and still what looks like a bunch of, you know, really inappropriately bad looking caps that have no business being on any kind of a board at all. But we can't even begin to see if that's a problem, because this board currently does not have a power management chip. So we really can't do anything to test without a power management chip. So we've got some bridges, we've got some solder balls, we've got some big blobs here for no reason. This looks like some kind of a graveyard over here of, I don't even know that these things belong here. It looks like somebody started like a little collection of you know, tombstones over here for some reason. This chip is a fun one because it has balls on one side. It's like a Jekyll and Hyde chip. Balls under the chip on one side, and then on the other side it has no balls. It's completely flat on the board. So there it is on the other side, mashed down onto the board with no balls whatsoever. So that's not cool. And here's one of the bigger problems. The power management chip has been removed, along with, I think I counted, 8 essential pads that have been ripped off. And some of them are going to be really tough to put back because they are kind of internal short jumpers, like this one, for example. This goes here. So we got to put a jumper there and then put a chip on top, and the jumper can't move. And neither can the other 7 that it needs. So what else do we have going on here? We've got a lot of ugly lists. Now, in order to get data from an iPhone 5, and of course this is only for data recovery, it's going to need the negative boost IC, which lives here, or used to live there. When it used to, once back in its younger days, it was a beautiful thing, and it had 8 beautiful pads here at one point. Now there's only 4 left, so those are going to also be a required chip if we want to have image in order to get this thing to work, which seems pretty unlikely. It's got some fuckery here at the connector. Compass looks like it's seen better days. And let's look on the other side, shall we? All right, what's going on over here? We've got some horrifying looking caps like this one. How do you put on how do you try to change the PMIC without taking off just severely ugly things like that? I have no idea. All right, what else? Let's see. Let's flip over here and I'll show you the real deal breaker, the real hell no, fuck no reason why I said I'm not putting a minute into this. And it is right here. This is a CPU And this is a happy little solder ball that decided to come out and play. Didn't want to hang out in there with all the other balls under the CPU. So that's that guy. And he's got a couple of friends, a couple of Mickey Mouse ears. So somebody has put heat here. So what's that chip? What would possess somebody to put heat on an underfilled chip? And it is the TriStar chip. Now, we know how TriStar fails. TriStar fails from charger damage, which is electrical damage, which means that if you have some kind of charger voltage punching TriStar in the face, TriStar itself is going to become internally damaged electrically. That does not mean it's going to magically fly off of its balls that are encased in underfill. So there's really no reason why you could do any good ever by putting heat on an underfilled chip like TriStar. So what has that done? We don't know, but we can see that there's a solder ball poking out of the CPU. That is not a good sign, and we won't really even be able to look at that until we start fixing some of this other nonsense. So this is a serious, serious rabbit hole. All right, yikes, where to start? Yes, I know. All right, so let's see. Vacation board for masochists. That's right. Okay. 2 hours and a sobbing hate fest at the end. Oh, I doubt it. I'm pretty tired. I've been here since, I don't know, early. I think we started at 10 today, and I've fixed a bunch of boards and then put some time just trying to clear these rabbit holes off of my desk. So where should we start? I think we should start with a little cleanup on aisle this one and just try to get some things back in order. So let's get started. And I've got a donor board here that I'm going to just kind of move stuff over from. So here's a nice, pretty looking iPhone. Wouldn't it be great if this was the iPhone 5 we were trying to fix? But no, this is not to be. So let's get started in here, just kind of cleaning up in this area so that when we do put a PMIC on, we'll be okay. Actually, before doing that, let's go look at ZXW. So let's have you guys come along. Take a little ride over here to ZXW land and screen, if that's gonna work. All right, so this is what I was really concerned about, which is what is the potential consequence here of too much heat at TriStar? I know that too much heat on TriStar can boil the CPU, so that's what I'm most concerned about. So the majority of the heat seems to be kind of in this area. So if I click over here and say what balls are gonna be affected, there's a whole lot of ground. All right, ground can bridge to ground, that's no big deal. NCs, that's no big deal either, but what about these ones? Who's this? This is PP1V2. So PP1V2 is at risk for being connected to ground. That would be a real deal breaker for putting time into this board. So that's the question that I kind of wanted to ask first. So what else besides PP1V2? This is PP1V2, this is also PP1V2. And then in here, we have some of this ambient light sensor interrupt, grape reset, that could give us a hard time, and some of these other interrupt lines. These are all neurons. And then here's a good couple of friends. There's a LCM power enable is somewhere around here. Oh, PP1V8. So the ones that are, that's really the closest here, PP1V2, I wanted to just check. So I'm gonna go up here and say, is this line short to ground before I put any time into this board? So I tested that and it was not short to ground. So we can test that in diode mode and click over on the multimeter and find out. So that is over here and we can put probe on ground and kind of measure these, and we're getting 0.321. I didn't bother to measure it on the good board, but that sounded pretty good to me. Let's go ahead and measure on the good board, and it's 0.319. So that's a match. That tells us that maybe, just maybe, we're going to get away with not actually having boiled the CPU itself, even though there was heat right there. So that's what kind of made me say, fine, let's put some time into it, really just for the sake of completeness. I mean, I get it. It's really tough if you have something precious on a phone and you really, really want to leave no stone unturned. So that's what we're going to do for these guys. All right, so let's get back to here. Okay, so let's see. You need to reball the CPU. Maybe, hopefully not. All right, looks like some kind of Wagner was used, maybe. Then the phone rang and the person forgot about the Wagner while it was laying on the board. That is possible. Okay, so let's try to straighten up. We're gonna clean our room here. All right, let's just kind of do a little windshield wipering around here because we really don't even know what in here is native and what has already been seriously messed with. Those guys all look horrible up there. So let's get some good caps here in this section. Let's get these guys off. Let's get some stuff heated up. And let's see what we can do for this board in about as much time as I want to spend on it in any one time. Likelihood of being fixed, low. But you never know. Every now and then it's fun to do one that's a real challenge. Let's go with the tweezers that are not magnetic. All right, let's get some of this party off the board. You're particularly ugly. You guys can stay. Are you alright up there, bro? Alright, what about you guys? One of you guys is definitely in the wrong spot. Alright. Let's clean that up. And get some new shit on there. We're gonna come through here and clean up these pads. Jessa, I hope you know your class has no choice but to troll this to death. You wait! This is gonna be amazing. This is no... We saw some crazy boards today. We saw a chestnut randomly cracked for absolutely no reason. Like, just didn't feel like being a chestnut. It would kind of commit suicide. We saw a VCC main short for data on a 5S that we found what was likely the original cause and then got trolled by somebody at one point having nudged the backlight driver but eventually figured it out. So we got that one in the done pile for the most part. We saw a fun one brought in. I do admire the students that have the cojones to show me their boards when they know that it's just going to be too hard for me to resist saying, what were you thinking? Like, hey, I'm doing a touch IC on Mason, and I have a VCC main short, so what should I do? I know. Take off the crystal. Just throw it away. What are you thinking? So hopefully they learned a little bit and are not going to do that stuff anymore. Where'd that little resistor come from? Where do you live, bro? I challenged Mark to see if he could find a bigger rabbit hole than my rabbit holes. He could not. So he's just going to do a little data recovery and leave and go home and go to sleep like a sane person. He's crazy. I don't know what's wrong with him. He doesn't want to stay here all night and work on rabbit holes. You're continuing to work on what? Oh, like the one I just worked on that was obviously bad, Nan?
Yep.
All right. Okay. Isn't this a pretty little walk in the park?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, have you tried taking the crystal off of it?
I have not tried to take the crystal off. I also... What do you think I should do for this, Mark? Look. I noticed that it's got a little bit of long screw damage. What should I do?
Which one is that? That's the one...
That's the one of... It's the iPhone 5.
It's the left side?
Yeah, by the power flex.
I would probably just fill that with solder.
I was going to do it. Fill it up with solder. Sounds like a great idea. We're going
to
fill it up with solder. Yes. And then you won't have to look at that long screw damage and think, God, what a horrible sight. Yeah, fill that shit up with solder. That's a great idea. I like it. Okay. Man. All right, so while this board is warm, we're going to have to finish the job here of scraping the underfill that's left. Believe it or not, there is some underfill left. We gotta get it gone so that our beautiful brand new PMIC can just sit and float. I bet the students are just hanging out at the hotel, drinking margaritas, probably laying in bed with their feet up, waiting to come back for an exciting day of fixing stuff tomorrow, instead of sitting here with this misery. They are smarter than me. All right, let's see.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, good night, Mark. See you in the morning. I'll be home like any, I don't know, what do you think? Is it going to take 20 minutes? Maybe? Max?
Yeah, you'll probably spend another 20 or 30 minutes on that board.
On?
I expect to be back about 2.
I'm going to be back by midnight. You wait.
Okay. If you're not back by midnight, you have to
I have to wear the Mark's special shirt.
Yeah, you gotta wear that all day tomorrow.
Yeah. See ya. There goes Mark saving himself. Oh, never. This is a lesson in why not to ever braid. Ever. Never braid, kids. Or this might happen. Or this might happen. Ben Nash says, hey, iPad Rehab. What up, Ben? Ben got trolled by a backlight that turned out to be connector. Just like I called it from half a globe away. Let's see if we can get this underfill residue off without pulling any more pads. Ah. No, you don't. No, you don't, bro. Please, bro, stay where you are. All right, how are we doing on this border? Seems okay. I haven't even bothered to check to see if it has a VCC main short. I'm going to wait until much later. Still a little bit right here. You gotta make it so the chip can dance. He's gotta be able to dance and find his own way in the world. I don't think I'm gonna press my luck anymore on that. Yeah, but didn't you say a different part of the connector, not the solder joint? Yeah, I said you had an open line between the screen and the board, which is exactly what you had. Although I did say it was going to be that you could just pull the pin out, but But it was the solder joint, apparently. All right. I need to go get a six-pack to continue to melt my brain tonight. I had both ideas that solved the sex toy mini and then argued against them. Yes, you did. Yes, you did. All right. Yeah, I wonder how many people watching stream have solved the sex toy mini. I was thinking it would be fun to get like little stickers that say, I solved the iPad Rehab sex toy mini. It's quite the classic now. All right, let's go ahead and put back some of these dudes from the donor board before we start tackling that PMIC. All right, let's put back some dudes. There's some ugly little soldiers laying around. God, just so many of these caps look just absolutely horrendous. All right, Jessa, have you seen the new Google Pixel 2? Nope. I do think when we were talking about potential rabbit holes that Mark could work on, we have, I think, a Google Pixel here with no schematics whatsoever that he briefly considered looking at. And then he said, you know what? Nope, I'm going to go home and go to bed. What a pussy. All right, here we go. All right, I want a shirt, damn it. Andy Bloss at one time was gonna make shirts that say, I solved the sex toy mini. I don't know whatever happened to that project. That was a while ago. I think that would be pretty funny. Beautiful board here, yes it is. Can you Google for Google schematics? That would be pretty funny. So I got a draft today of the new coming soon iPad Rehab website, which is shaping up, so it will be nice to kind of have a legitimate website that's not, doesn't look like it's made by a bunch of third graders in GeoCities or whatever that stuff was. Lewis also got a draft of his website, and that's pretty fun to watch. He's kind of having the opposite experience. I do feel really bad for him. It'll actually be really fun to see how that plays out. But his is, oh my god, horrible. It is nothing but copy paste of his existing relatively bulky website, except taking away the formatting he has and adding in lots of typos. And charging him a shit ton of money. So we'll all get to have a fun time watching Lewis lose his shit. Always a fun day. Hi, Jen. What kind of microscope are you using? I don't know. Is Jen somebody in stream? Somebody on chat? Somebody named Jen here? Hey, Jen. Anybody named Jen? Always good to have another chick on the stream. Tell us, Jen, you microsolder, what kind of microscope do you use? We're just going to pick these up. I thought Ben Duffy sorted your site out. Ben did a whole bunch of work, and I know how you guys are with your... You guys can't stand the whatever you call it, the sort of what looked to be kind of uniformy template-y style websites, which I can understand. However, I would argue that a template-y looking website is just kind of what people expect. So if you kind of stick with that format and genre a little bit, then it kind of just seems to just feel natural to people, I think. But what do I know? We needed something that would, you know, do store, We got our quicks in, so we put the quicks for sale on the iPad Rehab supply store today. So we're gonna finally start doing a better job of selling supplies and tools and equipment, which is really fun. It really means that I get to play with all sorts of stuff, and whatever seems to be really useful, then we're gonna sell it. So I got lots of fun stuff coming from China to try out. And we'll see what's good. Stencils is a big one. I want to solve the mystery of what stencil is really the best one. I love my personal Gesso stencil, but I have no idea where I got it from. And I do think that, like, sometimes stencils are like an individual one, like not even by a certain manufacturer, just that one stencil. Moshi Moshi Ding Dings, we are not going to be selling any kind of Moshi Ding Dings. At least I don't think so. I think the Moshi Ding Ding is disgusting. I have absolutely no idea why Sunday is in love with the Moshi Ding Dings. But she is. Who am I to judge? The course guys gave Moshi Ding Ding a urethra today, now featuring urethra. All right, what do we have left that really needs to get back on here? What's under those two guys? This guy? This board is a Moshi Moshi Ding Ding. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. It's dirty. It's washed up. It's a has-been board. All right, let's not get too close to this. This is why it's hilarious to comment on iPad Rehab streams. Hilarious. Hilarious. All right. Let's make some kind of bet with the course people. How about this? If this board works, then we don't start the course until noon tomorrow. How about that? Sounds good to me. All right. There's no sense in it having a backlight coil, because this thing ain't never going to have no kind of backlight again. By the way, if I fly back to Atlanta and we haven't sat down over some beers, I'm gonna be mad. We'll see. Well, then we'll have to have some beers at the course. What are you actually working on? This is a rabbit hole data recovery, giant waste of time. Chance of recovery, I'll put it 5%. That might even be a little generous. So this is a heavily raped, all kinds of pads missing from the PMIC. Solder balls popping out of the CPU. Somebody reflowed TriStar. Somebody tore up the negative boost IC, which is kind of the chestnut equivalent. We got that chip up there is only has balls on one side. All right, we're about to start our pad repair job. Break it up, you two. All right, what's above the coil? Oh, that's some other coil. All right, well, we'll put you back on. We'll put you back on, bro. Scraping is raping, yes. Just I need a microscope model. I will buy one soon. I do not want to buy the wrong one. Then you should click the video description and click on the link and buy that one. That's what I would do if I were you. Never good when balls are on one side. That is true. All right. Keeping on, keeping on. How about this? Let's make some other kind of bet with the students. If this board doesn't work, then I will not make fun of any student repairs tomorrow whatsoever. Since I'm not taking my own advice to not work on rabbit holes. This is clearly a rabbit hole. Aw, fucker. Gotta get some more flux up in here. Alright, everybody go back home. Okay. Alright, let's see what's under that diode over there. Uh-oh. Hot air has gone five, that means 500 seconds have gone by. Hot air's freaking out. There we go. So the town has another lost dog that looks exactly like the first lost dog that was finally found. You can tell that the old ladies of the town are actually super excited that this little dog is lost, because they get to say things like thoughts and prayers every day, have something going on. So I'm excited for Halloween. I am going to dress up Underdog, my little black pug. He is going to be a little white sheep. But I gotta make him this little sheep costume. I think that's gonna be hilarious. My twin girls are gonna be the Shining Twins. And they look totally exactly like the Shining Twins. And they're all like super shy, so it's really natural for them to just stare and say nothing. So they're a total shoo-in. Alright, what do we have left over here? All right, coil, cap, and this dude under there. Let's grab him, why not? I should dress up my pug. You should! Yeah, Tim's got, I think, a white pug. He used to have a fawn pug. And we made her be a bumblebee one Halloween. That was really cute. We got a hula, like, grass skirt. And a little hula top. Hula pug, always good. Good times. All right. Dressing up Underdog as the Rossman mascot. That is true. I did not think about that. That's pretty funny. We'll have to do something with that. So I did ask Lewis to finally tell me what his plan, since he's obviously never going to get around to doing it, what his plan was for his green screen troll for iPad rehab. Sounded pretty funny. So he was going to put himself in my house and decorate it. Maybe he'll still do it, so we'll see. But it sounded pretty funny. All right, what's under there? Now we do have to care about missing resistors and stuff like that. Halloween is a better holiday than Christmas. All holidays are pretty good. Man, this is already just a ridiculous amount of effort for no good reason. No good reason at all. Are those little things capacitor? Some of them are, yeah. We're gonna make this board respectable again. It doesn't have to hang its head in shame. Well, let's go grab these three guys. All right. Halloween really means one thing in the US. It means that all the stores can start playing Christmas music the day after. My girls were born on November 1st, which is a really shitty birthday, I think. They think it's pretty cool. It's shitty for a parent because you have to plan. I gotta get four kids all ready for Halloween with all their crap, and I gotta drag them around the town and... You're all focused on that. And then the very next day, you have to be already planned and ready. God damn it. Just blew one off the board. Well, he can kiss my ass. The very next day, you gotta have cake and balloons and... God damn it, I blew them both off the board. Oh well, fuck those guys. All right, what's under there? I think I did not come around there and tin it. Halloween means the first snowfall of winter. Yeah, this Rochester weather is nuts. It's going to be 76, so hot, on the weekend. What the fuck? What are you doing here?
Somebody's making me answer tickets.
Answer tickets? Are you sure you didn't just come back here to take a shit? Because that's not going to be cool. I think Mark totally just showed up here to take a shit. Let's see. Alright, where was I? This guy. Alrighty, let's get some more solder on these pads. And let's see. Halloween used to mean cheap candy. It kind of does, like the day after Halloween, I'm guessing. If you go to Rite Aid, you can probably score big on the Halloween candy that nobody bought. Gotta get that pad off. What goes there? I don't even know. This is giving the good old JBC a workout. All right. So do you guys think that it's going to be hard to find the Nintendo Switch this Christmas season? What do you think, Mark?
No, I think that everybody that really wants one already has one, so the people that haven't gotten one yet are not going to have one.
They don't really give a shit.
Yeah. What's going to be impossible to find, and already is the SNES Classic.
What?
They made, like, Super Nintendo, a new, like, release of the Super Nintendo that's got a bunch of games built into it.
Hasn't, like, there been things like that for a long time?
Well... Not from Nintendo. They did a NES Classic a couple of years ago. That
what's the difference between NES and Super NES?
The the games. The, I think one's 8-bit versus the other one's 16-bit.
Do they both have, like, square basketballs, so who cares?
Well, the Super Nintendo is slightly less square.
Okay.
There are more squares that are smaller.
So that's going to be in demand, according to your calculations.
Oh, it already is.
Is
they,
it?
Yeah, they like the pre-orders are done, and nobody can get them anymore. And I haven't checked eBay, but I know when they ran out of the NES Classic, they were selling for like $600 on eBay.
Oh, you know what I saw was something you could pre-order. This is so stupid. Fucking Hatchimals. And guess who, like, really wants that for her birthday?
Bamazy.
Yes, Bamazy. Yeah, so we're, like, looking at him, like, what's a Hatchimal? Some stupid fucking egg toy? Like, it's,
yeah.
Oh my God, so fucking dumb.
Yep.
And I look on Toys R Us, like, pre-order a Hatchimal? Oh my God, no. Just N-O. And so it's like, you know what would be really fun, girls? This would totally be more fun than a Hatchimal. Let's dye Easter eggs in November. Yeah! I mean, like, this is just super easy to make kids have a good time for free. Hatchimal. What a dumb idea.
Somebody doesn't think it was a dumb idea.
Are you going to get Max a Hatchimal?
Hell no.
Why not?
Because
you're a sexist pig.
He gets
car toys and truck toys, and he can't play with Hatchimals. Not Mark's child, no.
No.
No, it's not that?
No, he gets like...
How many Barbies does he have?
1950s wooden toys and stuff.
Oh, okay. How many Barbies does he have?
None.
What? Why?
No Barbies.
Why?
He's not really into any kind of dolls or action figures. Or
yeah,
because
his parents won't buy him any Barbies.
He's got stuffed animals.
Well, you know what he would really like to have? A Hatchimal.
No, he wouldn't like that.
We'll see. We'll see what happens next summer when he comes up to play with Betsy and Maisie's Hatchimals.
We don't watch TV, so he doesn't know about...
Yeah, how did my kids find out about this stuff?
You have TV that has commercials.
I don't have TV with commercials. That's crazy. Who watches TV with commercials?
The kids.
They do not.
Yeah.
How?
You got the thing. You, like, DVR it, so you guys skip the commercials. But
yeah.
Kids watch live TV.
They do not.
They probably
my
do.
My child does not watch live TV. What you talking about? No. No, I mean, I can remember, like, the kids were unaware that there was such a thing as live TV. And then they're like, what is this? How do you get off of this? I don't want to care about the sale that, you know, the car dealership. What? What is it? What happened to my show? And I'm like, that is a commercial. Well, how do we fast forward? You don't.
Same.
When
Max first started going over to Cecilia's parents' house, he would get really mad because commercials would come on during his shows.
Yeah, so it's like,
he's like, what
the
is
heck
this?
Is this? What kind of bullshit is going on? People are fucking my world. What's wrong? What is up? Yeah, it is mighty hard to explain the concept of commercials. It just seems so stupid when they're like, we've never watched... I'm 10 years old, I've never seen a commercial. Ever. My kids are at the age now where they're like, they're doing this to me. Like, I'll say something like, how do I get it on Amazon to watch the Charlie Brown pumpkin thing? And I'm like beating on it, and they're like, Mom, just give it to me. It's like, no part of the plan. Alrighty.
You haven't even put your PMIC on yet?
Oh, I had it on 3 or 4 times, but I just wanted it to be really straight, so I took it off. You know what a perfectionist I am. I just like have to have everything just so.
Alright, well, looks like you probably have about 39 minutes worth of work left.
Oh, less than that. Maybe 15. I think so. Carman used to watch commercials. My childhood is full of memories to mute the TV. I do think that is how you found out about things like Hatchimals. Like strawberry shortcake and all of the... What kind of stuff did you have? What did you want for Christmas when you were 10?
Oh, God. I have no idea.
Did you believe in Santa?
I'm sure I did at some point, but I don't know when that stopped being a thing. I don't know. My early childhood is a hazy, distant memory.
Did I tell you that Sam kind of confessed about Santa? He's like, Mom, I mean, he's been kind of, they're all in sort of a don't ask, don't tell mode with that. And so Sam was finally, he's like, all right, Mom, you know how the last straw when I finally really stopped believing in Santa. What was it? And he's like, it was because all this stuff that was supposedly from Santa said made in China. Like, okay, you know.
Yeah, the whole Santa thing worked a lot better back when, like, all of the toys were handmade.
Yeah.
Like, you know the elves aren't injection molding Hatchimals.
The elves are not making Hatchimals. I mean, like, it kids are smart, you know. They'll be like, isn't that some kind of, like, a copyright infringement? I mean, Hatchimals are like, you got to pre-order that shit. You know, Santa's just up there fucking making them. That's bullshit. You know, Hasbro should sue.
Yeah, my solution to that is going to be buy all the Christmas toys at Dollar Tree, but then don't ever take the kids in Dollar Tree throughout the year, so they don't know that these off-brands exist.
Ah. And then one day, it's going to be this, like, dark day. Oh, my God! Or they're gonna be like, you'll be able to be like, kids, for your birthday, I'm going to take you a special place. Santa's Workshop. And I'm going to give you $10. And you can get 10 things in here. Anything you want. Santa's Workshop. Let's all dress up and go to the fancy Santa's Workshop. Oh, man, that's amazing. Didn't you used to work at Dollar Tree?
I did, yeah.
What's like the best thing in there?
Some of the cleaning products you get a good deal on.
Like Windex?
Yeah.
Like actual Windex or Wandex?
Yeah, like Chinese-made window cleaning liquid.
Right, yes. What's like the worst thing in there?
Any of the food.
Yeah, I was gonna say, like, do they sell like off-brand Spam?
Oh man, like the nicer ones have like frozen sections.
Wait, there's nice ones and janky ones?
Yeah.
So did you work at a nice one or one of the shitty ones?
Not, like, my hometown was like kind of the worst of the worst.
Is it kind of like, I work at the dollar store. The nice dollar store.
No, yeah, like the GM for the one I worked at was always like whatever guy was on the shit list of upper management.
Oh.
It's like running that store was punishment.
Did you have like shoplifters?
Oh, constantly.
Who shoplifts from the dollar store? Like that's that you gotta
you
have like a
the customers.
What? That's like kind of mean, don't you think?
What? What for me what? To say that?
No, to no. Shop, to act, to be like, I know that the people that work here have to pay taxes, there's electricity, there's rent, this, you know, douchebag manager's got to make a living, they got to pay Mark, you know, they got to, and they're making on this piece of canned ham for $1, they're probably making 9 cents. Fuck them, I'm going to steal the $1 priced fake Spam and stiff these guys with a 91 cent deficit because I'm an asshole. Like, you know, that's just that's a whole level of, you know, I mean, it's not like stealing a Hatchimal where it's like, these shouldn't be this expensive. Fuck the people that made Hatchimals anyway for inflicting them those commercials on my kids, and now my kids want me to buy $70 eggs. Fuck you, I'm just gonna steal it. That you could at least kind of see how some people would think that. You know, it's not totally nuts. Not that nuts. Alright, time for PMIC. What else needs to lay back down around here?
How far away are you from trying this out?
Oh, like 10 minutes. So close. So close.
Yeah, 10 minutes.
All right, it's going to happen. It's going to be so great. 5-finger discount. This message is held for review. Ooh, let's see.
Did you put your negative boost on already?
I was gonna turtle back it here. What's up with this? What's up with this guy? Ooh, aerosol can window cleaner. Yes, we used to have that when I worked at the Crystal Pistol Pizza Palace. Pretty nice place. There were dead bugs that we had to clean up every morning. It was pretty sweet. Guess what my job was when I worked at the Crystal Pistol Pizza Palace?
Cleaning the windows.
Yes, and at age 17, I was a bartender. What? That was a sweet gig, let me tell you. It is super fun to be in age 17.
Is that legal?
I don't know if it was legal or not, but the alcoholic owner didn't seem to give a shit, and, you know, so, okay. There, we got that sucker off. Yeah, so that was really fun. Because we would have, like, regulars that would come in, and,
yeah,
you know, it was fun. You could mix drinks and talk to people. You could learn how to do tricks, like, can you tie a cherry stem into a knot with your tongue?
Of course.
Well, where'd you learn how to do that?
My mom.
Your mom? What'd she like? Mark, we're going to sit down. I'm going to teach you how to build a Play-Doh coil pot, and then I'm going to teach you how to tie this cherry stem in a knot, and then we're going to go out and get some beers.
Yeah, that's pretty much how it went.
Well, alrighty then. So I'm now erasing the beautiful braided pads and putting some good old fashioned tin on them. Tin these bitches up. All right. Do you think this? What percent chance do you think this has of working?
Zero.
Zero. That's a little low. I went with 5, which I thought was high. We'll see. Part of me thinks, yeah, it's totally gonna work. It's totally gonna work. I'm gonna go with the Pollyanna approach. I'm gonna be confident. I think that a confident microsolderer just kind of makes boards behave. This asshole is going to work, despite the copious amount of heat that's been on this sucker. All right, that's great. Now, let's make a couple of jumpers. How important do you think a line is that is called VREF?
How important is a line called VREF?
Yeah.
On PMIC?
Yeah.
I would think that is necessary.
Yeah, I went with necessary as well.
Yeah.
And how about a line called something something like CPU1V?
That's probably, you probably want that.
Yep. What about LCMPWREN?
Well, do you just want it to boot, or do you want to have an image?
I want to have an image.
Oh, then you're going to need that one.
Damn it. Actually, I wonder if you do. Like, maybe, why can't you just not tell the PMIC that you plugged in a screen, just let it tell the CPU, or whatever, Chestnut.
Yeah, just, like...
Yeah, why does the PMIC give a shit?
Just jump 1v8 into there.
Yeah, exactly. I thought about that. I thought about just, because the other end, it's funny that both ends are gone. So where it's going is missing, and where it comes from is also missing. So it's just like, let's just fucking put it on the outside of the house and just kind of, you know, go there. Well, V-ref.
You're going to make this fully functional and go back as a working phone, right?
Wow, Starman says 75% chance of it working.
Whoa.
Yes, exactly.
He has not spent enough time around here.
Yeah, that's what I like about this stream is that, you know, I think that because we stream a lot of stuff that ends up fixed, that the boring shit piles phone after dead phone after dead phone of fuck this doesn't really get the same amount of play. All right,
just,
so let's
just start doing the 16-hour streams of just no fix.
Yeah, today we're not going to fix anything.
No fix Tuesday.
No fix Tuesday. Yes. We are going to have tacos while we do it, though. All right, let's start on these pads. Let's take it from the top. Great news, that one is NC, but his buddy is important. I think that guy is VREF. Let's go on a hunt and find out if that's true. Where is ZXW?
Oh, you got 5 minutes.
I'm almost done, obviously. I'm just going to wrap this up. I'm just going to tie a little bow around this.
Real quick while I keep one of them up.
Yeah, see, VREF goes right there. I'm going to go with VREF is going to be, I'm going to put that in the got to be there category. So we're going to go ahead with, we're going to need some VREF. All right, what jumper wire would you use? Ooh, I'm going to use mark wire. Sweet. Now, I'm going to be done in like 5 minutes.
That's where it went.
Shit. Shit.
That's okay. Son of a bitch. I was looking for
you're getting everywhere. Low on this, by the way. Ever since it came to live up here.
Oh, I've got like 20 miles of it at home.
Sweet. That's great. Because I'm going to use about 10 miles on this job. All right. Where did that fucker go? Yeah, this is going to be... So I'm going to speed up so much by not having to wind this out of some kind of a coil. You got a little Jimmy leg going there, Mark. I'm a professional. I don't sweat your tap.
It's a nice
tap.
Microscope stand you got there.
Yeah, I got it on Lewis Rossman's recommendation.
Yeah.
Did you see that he got an articulating stand? That's what I can't stand. It would be like you getting an articulating stand, where it's like years and years of bitching about what shit the articulating stand is, and then, oh, let's see what I'm going to pull out of this box. I got myself a nice...
Well, obviously he got it so that he could review it poorly.
Well, he gave it a great review.
Really?
Yeah, he's let's gone
see
nuts.
See what he thinks about it in 6 months.
I told you, he's lost his mind. He's gone crazy. So what'd you think of his website?
Looked...
Totally profesh?
Yeah.
What would you do if you were him about that whole website deal?
I don't know. I mean...
Cry?
Yeah, I don't really know what he can do besides, like...
He can get real pissed.
Yeah, get really mad.
He can get really drunk. And then he can go fight random New Yorkers.
To his... like YouTube following and make him wish he hadn't.
Oh, he's what would it take for him to not do that?
Getting his money back?
Yeah, exactly. I mean, that's there's no way that the guy, I mean, the guy's an idiot. I mean, the guy sat there and like copy pasted his whole website. He sees the kind of, you know, douche speak, like, you know, don't come to my course if you're buying boards from eBay, you asshole, because they're not gonna fucking work. You know, like he knows that this is a, you know, angry guy from New York, and what can you predict is going to happen when you fuck this job so horribly?
There's no way that more than 30 minutes worth of work was put into that. So
yeah,
you know, the guy really needs to just give him his money back, and the reason he probably doesn't is because the guy probably went on freelancer.com and hired somebody in India to
yeah,
do
absolutely.
It for $50.
Right. Well, the guy, you know, the guy just kind of would think no one would actually expect you, you know, like it's like if you work in this industry, no fix, no fee is a thing. You kind of you know, like that job, holy fuck, you know, how much money do you make from all the time you put into that? Nothing. And so it's kind of accepted. But if you were, if you go to, you know, Walmart and say, let's negotiate the price of these socks, or the dollar store, well, you take 90 cents. You know, it's like not really as accepted.
Well, I don't know what the usual, you know, transaction, you know, the way it usually works with getting websites designed, but it seems to me like it's a bad idea to pay in full before the job is done.
He didn't pay in full. He paid a serious deposit.
Yeah, well, even that, like, it's, I don't know.
Yeah, it's kind of like, I'm going to draw you a picture, but first pay me. Well, let me see the other pictures you drew. Okay, here's your money. I don't like my picture. Well, that's too bad. I don't know. I mean, I guess there's the reason why they would get a deposit is because there's probably a whole lot of, yeah, I don't like this picture. Or just people getting nuts, you know, like, what if you try it in size 12 font? What about 14? No, go back to 12. No, 14. No, 12. Like, that's what I kind of feel like it would be like. All right, next missing pad. So one missing pad is done. How about this one? This one. Do you think we need CPU 0? 0 doesn't sound important. Switch S?
I mean, you've already got CPU 1.
Yeah. I guess YouTube was just glitched out. All right, I'm going to go with that's probably going to be also important. Let's see where it goes. It doesn't go anywhere. Great. We don't really need it. Oh, yeah. I know this guy. This guy makes the CPU 1v1 rail. Yeah, see? Totally called that. All right. So, yeah, I know for sure that guy's important. So, that is going to be a required jumper number 2. So, I'm almost done. Just going to put a couple more of these in. Whoa.
Okay. Well, you're 1 minute over your 10-minute time.
You need to... You know what your problem is, Mark? Fucking crystal's not working in your watch. So what was the funniest repair that you saw today?
Well,
you didn't really see any repairs. Well, I have no idea what you saw in the back, in Mark's hovel.
I saw a very big pain in the ass previous attempt at water damage repair.
Yeah.
Still back there, 70 milliamps.
Oh, a rabbit hole?
Yep.
Yep. Well, we did get to see what a phone looks like that has no crystal today. That was cool. Did you actually see that?
Yeah.
Huh. I think that's kind of a cool thing. If you're the student that you like, wow, the board I brought like made Mark like come out. It's pretty cool.
Yeah, and it's nice to see that like I have never failed to think maybe it's the crystal, and
right.
You know, it's like I saw that and was like, okay, I've never seen that before, good.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, instead of being like, oh shit, all those ones that went, oh god, they were all just crystal problems. Yeah, that would suck. That would really suck.
Now on a Samsung, if you take that same crystal off, they also have a 24 megahertz crystal.
Uh-huh.
It sits at 50 milliamps.
Does it? So it doesn't flash or anything?
No.
Well, there you go. Now we learned something else today. I mean, it was a lot of weird stuff, like a cracked chestnut for no reason. That kind of makes you, like, just wonder, like, is it a troll? Like, if I was going to the course, I would do stuff like that. I'd be like, hey, let me take this board, take the shield off, take a tiny little hammer and go, tink, tink, and, like, crack some weird chip and put the shield back on and be like, history is unknown.
It had to have been from, like,
the
board
factory?
Flexing or something.
No way.
If it was from any sort of external force or tool or anything like that, there would have clearly been a mark in the black coating on the chip.
Look, we're like good all the way up to here. Look at this. That one's done. That one's done. Those have got, that's no stuff. That's got to be no stuff. Ooh, that one I'm not sure about. That one might not be no stuff. Might go to there. But that's no stuff, no stuff, no stuff, no stuff. Almost certainly. That's no stuff. That's got to be no stuff. These are all going to be ground, so who cares? So I think we're like good up to here. That's like half. Speeding up. Now I do need to go back and check on this guy. So let's go check. Let's go on a hunt and check. All right, so we have no stuff, no stuff, no stuff. Yay! No stuff, no stuff. Yay! And then I think we're good over here. So let's click back. Let's move it up. All right, so we have two dudes there, and then we have 1, 2, 3, and then two no stuffs, and then this guy is our next problemo. So what is he? Come on, this guy. What do you think? Do we need PP5V1 grape? How important is PP5V1 grape? What do you think? What do you think, Mark? Just blow it off. Fuck it.
I mean, you don't really need grapes in an iPhone.
Speed of electricity through conductor does not equal the speed of light in a vacuum. Whoa, what are those? What are they talking? They are not talking about Hatchimals. What is this in driving me in stain? What are they talking about? Jessa, have you been in Lewis's store? Yeah. It's small, like a closet. Yes. Yes, I'm
That's
aware.
It's more like a hallway.
It's like a...
It's like a bunch of closets connected together.
It's like a dorm room. A bunch of closets connected together. That's pretty funny. All right, so the next one that we're going to need is this dude, which is this guy who probably comes from there. So we will run a jumper from that microvia there. We'll just lay some pipe right up in this mov. All right, you know what's going to suck is I'm going to forget to really measure for VCC main short until after I put the PMIC on, and then I'll be like, oh, shit. Now I don't know if it's under the PMIC or not. It's hard to get these ancient ass fucked traces to take some nice healthy leaded solder like a man. Come on, man up, board. Trouble is, too many people underestimate the intractability of websites, especially the people selling website building services. They're worse than programmers. Well, I think the thing is, you know, we did this kind of at the same time, where what we both wanted wasn't a website, it was a website designer. I mean, we've sat there all winter long. I mean, that was all we talked about, was building stores and websites and whatever. And, you know, I got trolled horribly on my sad efforts to make a new website, which I had no appreciation for page speed, so I'm like learning how to make all these awesome sliders and add a video and a, you know, then it's like, all right, let's look at the page. Okay, refresh. and then it was just like, yeah, that's horrible. No one will ever click on this. Just like no solder will ever stick to this fucking trace. I've been putting flux on here like there's pools of it.
Yeah, but it's not a.
I know. Well,
I
got two hands full of other shit, so I want it to just work. You know why? It's shit, Mark. Because I ran out of chip quick and I'm forced to use this shit. That's my problem.
Well, that stuff works if you have it on the place you're soldering on.
Well, let's see. Oh, fuck. Damn it. God damn it. Now this is a real... Now the chance that this is going to work just went down.
This was never going to work.
What are you talking about? This thing is going to work great.
Nope.
I'm going to wear it around my neck like a necklace. If this actually works, this board's going to be one of my fucking pets. And I want to put my pets, like, up. Like, I want to, like, have little stories and, like, little, like, shadow boxes. This is pet board, 100%. This guy's going to be... Mark, do you have any pets?
No, I don't.
Why?
I don't know.
What's, like, the coolest thing you ever fixed? You didn't keep your shoestring jumper S3 port?
No, that went to a customer. That's
what? That's yeah. Still in somebody. It's probably that's plugged right. Into a charger right now somewhere.
Yeah. that charging port never disconnected.
Uh-oh, we're getting in trouble.
Ever again.
What's that? What's... Does he know that we're talking about him on stream?
Who? With Lewis?
Yeah.
Oh.
I'm afraid I'm going to be in trouble. He sent a link to some video. What's that video? Is it about a web designer?
How am I going to stop?
Oh, I'm not fucking watching that. No. Back to work. All right. Let's get this laid down on here. All right. So what was it like to talk to the band people of... Mega Mouth or whatever it was. Mastodon.
Oh, they were cool. I mean, it's all right.
It's all right. Did you kind of feel like a total, like, kind of customer or like a, hey, man, you know, lots of people come see me from all over, too, you know? Was it like that? And they're like, we don't give a shit.
Yeah, I don't know. It was just, like, talking to a person. It wasn't...
Huh, that's weird.
Yeah.
Just like talking to a person. So what did you do? Did you get to, like, sit down on a couch and be like, so, what's your favorite color?
No, there's no couches.
So what did you say to them? Like, I really love your music, dude. Like, so love it. I don't know why people say it sounds like you guys are just banging pots and pans and screaming. They don't get it, you know?
No, I didn't.
I was going to offer, like, if this little concert didn't work out, that I was going to have Betsy and Maisie bang pots and pans and scream and, like, turn the lights out and you guys could get some lighters out or something like that. It'd be pretty much the same, obviously, so that you wouldn't miss out. All right, this long-ass janky jumper. All right, what's going on? Good at math. How would one calculate the distance something is away using some equation to measure RF, which is the same speed as light? Sounds like Tim needs to go do his homework. That's what it sounds like to me. Tim, don't make me tell your dad that you're asking people in stream to do your homework for you. That's not cool. Right.
I think you're looking at chat from like 20 minutes ago.
What are you talking about? No, it's live. Or not.
Yeah.
Wow, it's 6 a.m. iPad rehab, I have a question. Which type of soldering paste do you use to reball everything? I use mechanical high performance, and I have a lot of problems because I can't reball. I use whatever kind is closest to me. There's nobody uses anything other than the one that comes from China in the can.
Yeah, same stuff.
Yeah, mechanic brand. There's no high quality. It's
See, his problem is he's like closing the cap on it.
Oh yeah. Do you store it in the fridge? No, I don't. All right, I'm gonna have to stick that one down a little bit more. All right, where are you supposed to go? Right there?
Yeah, that's good enough.
Is it or is it? Look at that beautiful little pad. It's all round and everything. Not exactly. I'm building a Doppler radar. Well, not building, but upgrading. Time to get out the FCC book. Yeah, I would go to how to build Doppler radar and just follow instructions. And if I didn't know, I would go to the Doppler radar forum and I would say this: please, bro, help me build a Doppler radar. Is there another kind of radar that's not Doppler radar? Like, what's the other kind of radar?
I have no clue.
What about police gun radar? Is that Doppler radar? What does the word Doppler mean to you?
The sound of a train changes when it goes by.
Yeah, exactly. Where it's like, it's ambulance. Yeah. That's all I know. That's it. That's the end of the file under Doppler. The sound of the ambulance changes and something about radar, period. File, seal, lick the envelope, stick it in. That's all that's in there. All right, so that one's done. Great. So now I've done one, two, three. I thought I needed eight, though. And that one's a little bit too...
How did you find the problem in doing this jumper?
What do you mean, find the problem? Well, what? Oh, is that a question? Yeah. Oh, did you find the problem in doing this jumper? He's calling you a hoe.
He's talking to you.
No, nobody's going to call me a hoe on stream.
How did you find the problem there to do that jumper? And looked at the board.
I went to the internet and I said, please, bro, how do I rebuild a fucked PMIC? I'm looking around to see what many, many, many pads here are missing, and I am putting them back. Ish.
Tim says, Doppler is a little different. It measures the shift in frequency when the wave bounces off of something. Regular radar will just send a pulse and listen for it.
Okay.
Doppler radar is a form of radio transmitting that needs to follow the rules of the FCC.
The FCC. How does the rest of that song go?
I don't know the FCC song.
What? It's like an Eminem song. What are you talking about?
I don't listen to country.
That's not country. It's fucking Eminem.
I don't listen to candy.
I just listen to noise and banging on pots and pans. I don't have time. The FCC won't let me be. Let me be me and something else. That is unfortunately going to have to be edited because it's too weak. And it's going to have to get the fuck out. Too weak. Get out. Get out. Are you sitting there thinking, you know, my streams are always like 8 minutes long. This is retarded. Nobody wants to watch this.
I'm trying to get in and out with as few people noticing that I'm streaming as possible. The only reason I stream is because I don't want to have to like deal with
upload a whole video.
Yeah,
so like, I'll just stream.
Like, look, it's 3 a.m. Let me just get a quick stream out and say hi to some guy in Zimbabwe. And then
I'm out.
Yeah.
All right. Listen to Eminem Country. Wait, Eminem has country? Sweet. All right, so my trace is below the two. All right, that's good. Ooh. Now it's got to be tinned or else it can't win. I'll just be super excited if this thing actually produces 5v1 grape. That's really
good. You
should
do little circles for all the NC pads.
All of them? For all the NC pads. Yeah. That's a great idea. I'll put that in the fuck you mark category. All right, let's scroll on down this side and see if this guy is important. I'm going to go with he is. I think that's VCC main, so he's in the number 3 position from the bottom. Let's go give him a check. The number 3 position from the bottom is... It is! It's our buddy, VCC main, which...
I bet it's connected to the other VCC mains on the chip.
I bet it's not. I really bet it's not.
I bet it is.
Do you really bet it is?
Yeah.
No, you don't.
Mm-hmm.
No, it's not. I mean, if it was, it would... Uh-oh. I feel like that's like my dad.
You know, like... Oh, I got caught.
Uh-oh, he says he gives up on the website? Oh, shit. I know what he's talking about. Oh, that's too loud. He's donating? What does that mean? That's not happening. All right. Let's tin up this. Alrighty. Let's make our chat window come back. All right. VCC main sounds like a rapper. That is pretty funny. All right, Mark, that's a good challenge. What? Pick the iPhone line name that would be your porn star name. Chestnut. Chetsnut.
I got nothing.
What? Nothing?
I have to pull up the list of them.
How about Turtle I see? Hey, what's up, Turtle? It's a good nickname. Why don't we give everybody like chip name nicknames? So we'll start calling Christy like, you know, Chestnut, Mason, Cumulus, Agatha. Well, let's all just be the girl names of the PMICs. You can be whatever one's the closest to like unisex, which is probably Addie.
I think.
Do you want to be Allison?
No.
Do you want to be Agatha?
No, I don't.
All right. Well, what are the other ones? Do you want to be... You could be Fiji. Yeah, that'd be cool. You could be Fiji. I'll be Allison. Because I've said so many times, oh, that bitch Allison.
No, I want to be Stockholm.
Stockholm? I want to be backlight driver.
LM3539.
Yeah. Yeah, what ship like never goes bad? I'm gonna be Oscar. Oscar never gives anybody any problems. Oscar's laid back. Oscar, you know, just kinda doesn't give a shit. I mean, getting that coating off, I'm gonna have to use like an X-Acto to get that tinable. It's just too juicy with this piece of shit Amtech. Oh, man. Watch out for touch disease. What does that mean? Mine is Ted Kramer, childhood pet's name and childhood's street name. Childhood's pet's name is Petey, and childhood's street's name is First.
Yeah.
Petey First.
Mine would be Dog Fourth.
Dog Fourth. My other pet's name was Yalzu. He was a cat. My first pet that I had as an adult was a little orange cat named Scram. He was kind of an asshole. He was really a total asshole. Alright, maybe we can get some tin on that. On that bitch. Alright, what is this? Who keeps posting about this same touch? Why don't you answer that?
What? It sounds like probably it's booting to DFU.
What does it say? Read
the
it, read it out.
Air 2, is that what you're talking about?
Yeah, so whoever keeps posting the same thing.
Yeah, I need help. I just bought an Air 2 with charging problems. I can get the iPad to boot up by holding the home button and the power button at the same time for a quick second. So...
Okay, so you got you can throw it away.
I'm guessing he means that
yeah,
you can see the Apple logo.
Yeah,
and
then it and
then,
goes to DFU. Yeah. Yeah. Plug it into iTunes, and when iTunes says, hello, I recognize that you've plugged in something that's in recovery mode. Would you like to update or restore? You can say yes. It's going to fail, and you can put it in the trash. That's what I would do. And don't buy stuff on eBay. You're never going to get a good deal. You're instead going to inherit somebody else's problem. You're going to get a board like this. This is a board I might sell on eBay. This was my iPhone 5 not working. Could be just the screen. Can you imagine? What would be the funniest listing on eBay for this board that could still be truthful? May have been in water. Have not tried toothbrush and alcohol.
iCloud lock needs work.
It's probably not. Any advice for grayed out Wi-Fi? No.
iPhone 5 logic board, some assembly required.
Some assembly required. I've never tried it with a known good. I've never tried it with a new battery, so don't not really sure what would happen if I did. My guess is that it would catch on fire, but I don't actually know that for sure. All right, now we got to get another mile of mark wire. So where'd you get this wire?
Amazon.
All right, I think you meant iPad Rehab Supply.
Oh.
Yeah. Why don't you know what? I'm just gonna start. I'm gonna start selling this exact one. I mean, just like you get an inch. That's all yeah. You're. It's really
enough,
a lifetime supply.
Enough for 10 trace repairs.
Yeah. And it comes with a free magnifying glass. Well, that's a beautiful, beautiful pad.
Oh, the iPad guy says no, the iPad does work.
Then you got no problem.
I even updated to the latest operating system.
Why'd you do that?
It's turning itself off and coming up to the battery symbol and it won't turn off.
Okay, so it won't charge.
Yeah, I mean, it sounds like this needs some diagnosis.
Yes. Yes, it does. Diagnosing what's wrong with your device over the internet is pretty hard. So what I would do is I would post on a forum or go to a repair shop or read everything that I could on that problem. What would you do, Mark? I'm going to stick it in the back of my queue under this thing.
Yeah.
Can't guarantee it, though. I really like the green tweezers, but they just don't last for more than a day. All right, that one's done. Yay! Now, I bet that's no stuff. And there's one that we're gonna need. Do we need this guy in the number four position, right here? Do we need that guy?
Oh, Jessa, the guy that called you a hoe.
Yes.
Wants to yeah. Know what is the best way to detect problem on iPhone logic board.
What is the best way to detect problem on iPhone logic board?
With
Here's
tools?
The thing. No. No, Mark. Clearly the guy doesn't have tools. Mark was getting ready to demonstrate over here. You can't see him, though. Most iPhone logic boards that don't work because they have a short. Short circuits generate heat. You need to know where it's getting hot. So there's really only one tool that you can use that you always have around, and I'm not talking about your lips. I'm talking about Mark's scrotum. So just go ahead and show him. We did use some receipt tape today to find a short. Didn't work out for me and the students, but for Mark.
Worked for me because I did
great.
It right.
1, 2, 3, 4. Well, ours was Q4. That totally should have worked. I would try to maybe externally charge the battery a few minutes to see what happens. Go from there. That sounds like a terrible idea.
Definitely not a phone number you can call right now and explain what's going
on. Wow. Yes, it's 911 675.
What's Lewis's number?
Oh, yes! 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 What is Lewis's number? Oh, I get it. He means he's donating to the Stefan thing. All right, let's see. Okay, we're going to... Is there a number I can call? Take a picture of that and send that to Lewis. That's the kind of shit that drives him crazy. I'm going to tell him right now. It is hilarious. I'm going to ask him...
So mad.
What's your number?
I have his cell phone number.
No, he changes it all the time. What's your number? And I know he'll tell me. Because... Hey, oh wait, he just posted it last night. I bet I can still scroll. Because a dude on live chat wants to call right now and ask about a repair. There you go. Okay, so let's see what it takes to do this number four. Number four position is dun 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 dun. I'm pretty sure that it's gonna be something we don't need. We can just skip it, I'm sure.
30 minutes past the 10 minutes.
That's not true, Mark. You're just trolling. Ah, LCD power enable. Fuck that line. Fuck that line. What does that possibly do? Nothing important. Nothing important, we know that. Okay, so another jumper coming up. Another jumper coming up. All right. If you really want help, Rossman Repair Group has a forum you can ask your questions on. Yes, or you could just post to their live chat because they always answer that. You just go to mailin.repair and they'll say chat in the window. Just start typing your question right
Steve.
In.
Steve. Don't do that to Steve.
Steve doesn't answer it at night. Lewis was answering it last night.
What,
so,
really?
Yeah, man.
Yeah, then definitely do that.
Definitely do that. That's a way to get real
Tell
help.
Tell him Jessa sent you.
Tell him Mark sent you.
No.
You'll get a special discount. You'll get special treatment. Oh, I can't say that. I was going to say if you log in as blank blank from the website design. That would be funny. All right.
Oh man. I was walking out of here like an hour and a half ago.
Yeah, well, you know, you can. If you really don't want to hang out, you don't have to, because you can just watch on you know, go home, lay in bed, like, you know, clearly all the students have either gotten drunk or gone to sleep. Yeah, are you undefeated in playing board games?
No. The boys always win, Mare Nostrum.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. They always win that, so I am like on a 2-win streak though.
Oh, are you playing Civilization this weekend?
Is that the plan?
Yeah, except that I want to do Aerial Adventures.
No, I want to play board games.
You want to play fucking Civilization instead of go climb trees and be in the woods?
I want to play the Terraforming Mars or whatever.
Yeah.
Something Mars.
Yeah, Terraforming Mars.
Yeah, I want to do that. That sounds like fun.
Does it? Is it a big long one?
I have no idea. I don't know anything about it besides the name.
Is that the one that's all set up in the basement?
I have no idea. The only thing I know about it is the name. And that Jeff bought some, like, expansion for it.
Well, he's going to be pretty excited then. Because I'm pretty sure that's the one that Christy and Zach came over to play on Sunday, I guess.
Yeah.
Might have been Saturday. And I just couldn't handle it. It was too, like, this takes forever.
Oh, the iPad Air 2 guy says he's fully aware that he needs to send it in. He was just looking for a general idea of why it's happening, and he would like to see you fix it on live stream.
Yeah. No, okay. You need to send that to Lewis for sure. All right. Yeah, that would be really funny to be like, let's do a live stream, Claude. Screw down the battery in this air. There you go, all set. That would be hilarious. Okay. There is another jumper. Okay. We'll fix that iPad Air on live stream if you send me a Hatchimal. How about that deal? Wow, why is it so dark? Like, something's in the way. You guys are really fun. All right. Did you read the schematic in multimeter to make the jumper? No, I just guessed. I have to stop doing YouTube. I have nothing constructive to say. What do you say? Because I've been sitting here answering questions all day and like telling stories, yeah, or whatever. So it's just like, no, I can't. And I'm completely wasting my time. It's fucking who knows what o'clock. All right, let's see. Are we done? That jumper's done. Let's keep on patrolling around. That's definitely going to be nose stuff. This is going to be nose stuff. That's probably hanging on by a deer thread. All right, what about this guy? Now, this guy, I think, is a clock line. Now, this one, I'm kind of tempted to skip. What do you think, Mark?
I would jump in
right
the
here
man.
In the corner. Clock line. She doesn't like it when people ask questions on live stream. She has no possible way of answering. There are literally hundreds of possibilities that's causing your problem. That's right. Okay. The adapter, I don't know. It's always a struggle. I had to unscrew a bunch of these things and kind of cobble this one together. So I have nothing.
Good luck
nothing
with an
to
adapter.
Say.
I bought 3 of them before I found the right.
Yes.
The right one that works.
If we
with my
find
microscope.
Out, then we will definitely let you guys know.
And the one that did work required me to wrap pieces with tape and just jam them into each other.
Yeah, Lewis did one last night where he was like, so, Captain Tape for the win. So
yeah.
Camera stuff spinning around. All right, let's go and check out the next jumper.
Oh my God.
This guy. All right, see? All right, so this is fucking Wi-Fi clock. Who cares?
Fuck it.
Right, I know, that's what I say. This one I'm actually tempted to say fuck it.
Yeah, just say fuck it.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm 100%
sure?
Positive that is not necessary.
What if...
Nope.
What am I going to say? You don't even know.
You're going to say something that the answer to is no.
We'll see. Are you ready? What if... this phone boots up just fine, except because TriStar has had heat on it, it does not connect to USB. So there's a path to data, except Mark said don't run the fucking clock to the Wi-Fi chip.
It's your whole scenario is invalid because the heat on the Wi-Fi is going to cause it not to boot at all because CPU has balls coming out of it.
Heat on the Wi-Fi?
Heat on the TriStar.
I already checked, and it does not... That was the first thing I did. I went and I looked around, and I saw that the nearby balls that are not ground are 1V2 line, not short. So I said, okay. That's why it's like... So how much does this go up in success percentage based on that new piece of evidence?
It's I'll raise it from definitely not going to work to...
almost certainly
not going to work.
Definitely not to absolutely not. Not even like a 1% chance.
Nope.
Nope.
No.
Well, what is it going to do?
It's going to.
Is it a 70 milliamp phone or is it a big ass short?
It's one of the two.
Both. Both of the same. It's 170. It's a 1 amp plus 70.
Yeah, it's going to be a big ass short that when cleared is then 70 milliamp. And it's not even going to be 70 milliamp. It's going to be like 49 milliamp.
Oh, so you think I got a clock problem? It's because I didn't. Because you think I'm not going to run this jumper? Well, ha ha! I'm going to do it anyway. Ha ha! So put that in your pipe, Mark. So here's my real question: do you think I'm going to have to put on more than one PMIC?
I don't think that putting one on is going to get screwed up.
No, like, I think a scenario where I'd have to do more than one PMIC would be there is a short, PMIC is getting hot, and then I just questioned it and then decide to do another one.
Yeah, I think that's like 50-50.
50-50, wow, okay. Yeah. All right, I think that would suck. I think if that did happen, that this would go in a box for 6 months, and then, oh yeah, remember this?
You're gonna have a lot of, like, outside around the edge balls that are, like, the solder's gonna follow those traces into the gap, and if the placement isn't 100% perfect, you're gonna have bridging.
Not gonna have any kind of bridging, Mark. I'm professional.
Yeah.
Oh, fucker. Get back down and stop. Stop being weak.
God, those lights are too bright.
What lights? The ones that are not showing up because it's like super dim? Oh, the like truck stop lights?
No, the one that's like right below the screen for me.
Oh my god, he like actually wrote the store's number. Should fucking post it. Sure. Hey, J-Bug, why don't you call? That's hilarious.
The chat's gone. I can't see the chat anymore.
Can't see chat at all? Uh-oh.
Did you stop using Restream?
Yeah, just now.
Complaining that it's laggy?
Yeah, let's see. 75% of powering on and acting normally. 20% of still working enough to get data. 5% of not working. Wow. Well, if it powers on, I'm getting the fucking data, I'll tell you that.
Oh, J-Bug said, I think in response to your Hatchimals thing, that you've got a deal. What's the address?
Oh, God. Wow. The address is one of those things that you have to look up by, you know, You gotta use your brain. Have you seen some of this like mean shit that Lewis says to people that call up and ask about like, how do I sign up for the class? He had like a really mean one the other day.
Yeah, that's the screening.
Yeah, exactly. He was like, I'm gonna sit here with you next to you and ask you, and then he writes this whole list of ridiculousness. To tell me why this is this and what the difference between this and this. If you can't figure out how to find the contact us section of the website. I don't know, man. You got a pretty shitty website. Great. All right. Is that it? How many jumpers do we have on here? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All right, that's no stuff. Ugh. God, do I need one here? Oh, boo. Maybe it can just sit on that little neck. In fact, I'm going to say that it can. If that's the other Wi-Fi one. All right, so that is in row 1, 2, 3. That needs to be down a little bit more. You are too close to the neighbors.
Wow, the tar man says there's only a 5% chance of it not working.
Oh, wow. I believe I can fly. Tar man believes in me, Mark.
I bet tar man plays the lottery, too.
I bet he doesn't. Tar man is smart. He doesn't play lottery. 1, 2, 3. All right, so it is... We gotta find out. Do we need... What is that dude right there? Let's find out. J-Bug, is your real name Raj? Is your real name Raj? Oh, okay. Okay. Let's see. I'm J-Bug. Does your mom know you're still up? Okay. Let's go over here. ZXW. All right. We're over here, and I think it's this one. Fuck me! God damn it. Boom! Fuck! Oh. This is just a train wreck. It's gonna work. It's gonna work. It's gonna work.
How far away are you from finding out that this doesn't work?
I'm super close. Like, I don't know, 6 minutes? Possibly. Like, I'm all almost. Right.
So, if 10 minutes was really
40. This is not how math works. Alright, so let's see. 1, 2, 3. It's not dog minutes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Alright, so let's see. I'm pretty sure that was the right one, but I am losing my mind a little bit. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Bing! Yep. Oh, hell. Oh, damn. TriStar interrupt. I think TriStar needs to be interrupted. It's good for his health. So that means it's too important for me to just say, can't you just sit on that little nub? So it's going to have a little tiny, tiny little piece of wire. But I'm going to speed up. I'm going to speed up now. You know what used to be great about stream? The camera would run out of batteries. Those were the good old days.
Mine does that.
Does it?
Yeah, the one I have pointed at my hands.
Oh, yeah. Oh, fancy. Got a hand camera. All right, we're going to have a little piece of shit one that's going to be too small and highly likely to decide that it wants to move on to greener pastures and not sit under this chip. And it's going to bridge everything. All right. We are going to stick you down like a boss. So what are your favorite tweezers?
The blue
guys?
Magnetic ones.
I know, isn't that sad? I hate that they're magnetic. I cuss them constantly, but they're my favorites.
Yeah.
They're my faves. Yeah, I hear you. Alright. Well, that one's done. Ding, ding. Beautiful. All right. Please let that guy just not fucking matter. Please don't matter, bro. All right. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. The neighbors of 7 and 8. Who are the neighbors of apartment 7 and apartment 8? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Ding. Oh my god, it's the other end of that asshole. Fuck me.
You don't need both of them.
Oh. God, so that stupid jumper, like, oh my god. Oh god, how did I not even see that? Flick, fucker. Fuck me, god damn it, boo! Boo, fuck! Ah! Does this look retarded? So you think, what do you think battery SWI is? Doesn't sound important.
The battery switch. Obviously.
Okay. It was funny, like earlier when we were trying to find that one short, it felt like playing a scratch-off. I feel like I'm playing a scratch-off now and losing horribly. Especially this jumper that I just did that now is just too short. Like, he needs to go right there. So that one now no longer counts. God damn it. All right, so you are getting deleted. The good news is that I'm gonna let you be my new buddy. Battery single wire interface line. Good old gas gauge. That would suck if, like, everything worked except for that jumper and this thing would be like, oh my god, it boots! Oh shit, it reboots every 3 minutes. And that would suck. It's gonna go on out to the good old original FL11. Battery SWI. Alright, let's get rid of his tail. God, I wish I could just say fuck you, the Wi-Fi. The stupid Wi-Fi.
Damn, they're connected on the chip.
I took off the one jumper.
Oh. Well, you don't need it anyways.
I know. I wish I may say fuck Wi-Fi tonight. But I can't. I also wish this guy hadn't fucking ripped a braid through this whole section.
Been watching Lewis.
Yeah, exactly. I blame you, Lewis Rossman, your fucking wick. Put your wick where the sun don't shine. Your closet. He put a Craigslist ad for Oreo. Isn't that sad?
He's getting rid of Kitty?
Yeah, Oreo doesn't clean his ass ever. And so he, like, you know.
But doesn't, like, Mr. Clinton do it for him or something?
No.
No?
Nope. No, he does not. And it's almost like this whole, like, kind of passive-aggressive thing with Oreo and his asshole. So he, like, came back from one of these trips, and he's like, it's just shit everywhere.
Ugh.
Yikes. Yeah, so everybody's got an asshole pet. Which one do you think is the best of the asshole pets? I think Underdog.
Yeah, Underdog's alright.
He's alright. Alright, we don't even have chat open. That's fucking lame.
Yeah.
Jessa, do you know about phone software as well? Phone software. Not sure there's much to know about phone software. Like what? What do you mean? Tell us. We love to answer questions. The most creepy thing is wasting your time here assuming you know everything about this job. Make a space for those who are eager to learn, Aaron.
I think Hassan and Aaron have been going back and forth.
Ooh.
Hassan wants to know how you know to put jumpers here.
I want to know how anyone would not know that you should put jumpers here. When you see broken shit, it's supposed to be a wire and it's a blank space, and you see a torn wire, and then how do you not think, maybe I need to put a jumper there? How does that not occur to you? That's what I want to know.
Tarman says, wish I lived closer. I'd take Oreo.
Well, he'll mail them to you.
Yeah, I was going to say, call up his shop and tell him.
Yeah, make it happen. All right, I'm going to tell Lewis right now. Hey, great news. Tarman will take Oreo. Sweet.
Even better if Tarman lives outside of the U.S.
Tarman. No, he doesn't. He lives, like, in Buffalo or something. Tarman wants to...
Oh, that's a short trip.
I know. Take Oreo. Sweet. There. Problem solved. Look at that. Connector of people. Okay. Are we done? Let's see. Dun-da-da-da. Dun-da-da-da. All right. There's... Oh, yeah. Those three... Those are going to be ground. Here, let's answer our buddy. What's our buddy's name? Hamza, Hamad, Hamid, Hamdit, something like that.
Hassan?
Hassan, yes. Yes, Hassan. Here we go. Hassan. Let's look. See how there is a dot, a dot, a dot. I don't know if they can see my cursor.
Yeah, they can
see. Let's see. A dot, a dot, a dot, a dot, a dot. Nothing. Nothing. A dot, a dot, a dot. So there's missing dots here. You tell me What do you think they used to be connected to? Because I see a big, like, lattice here. Looks like a torn part. You tell me what goes here. What should it connect to? How would we know? All right, so that's ground, so we're skipping it. All right, now let's make sure that these two, ooh, this little pad of mine, I'm gonna let it stay right where it is. Do you think that could hit that ball? Probably could. All right, I'm pretty sure that those are no stuff, so let's just check. So we're gonna go over here and check. We're gonna ask our buddies in China. Hey, China, what's up with these? We'll put Hamza out of his misery. 1, 2, 3, 4. They're all ground. Yay. All right, and then in
jumpers there.
Yeah, but they're jump that all up with a big old ground sandwich. All right, so then we have no stuff. All right, so I am gonna just check.
It's done. Slap it.
Is it done? Did I miss one? I'll be pissed if I missed one. All right, no stuff. That's definitely no stuff. So 1, 2 jumpers. 3 little jumpers, 4 little jumpers, 5 little jumpers. I don't think I need anything there. Let's
slap
click over
on
here.
One of the Chinese reballed PMICs that were bad to begin with.
Yeah. All right. I do have some really bad news for you, Mark.
What?
I don't want to tell you. It's going to be depressing.
I can take it.
You can?
Yeah.
All right. Are you ready?
Yep.
Okay. I regret to inform you that I intend to put green stuff on here.
Oh, my God. No, don't put... If you were good, you wouldn't
I know.
Put green stuff.
I know.
But I would put a PMIC on there with no green
I
stuff.
I know, but...
I never use green stuff.
I know. I am weak. I am weak.
The only time I use that is covering up long screw damage repair just so that future idiots can't damage it.
I know. I'm weak.
You are. Oh,
there's Mark. And in order to do that, I want it to be pretty clean and dry. So I'll be right back. Woo!
Oh my god. I hope it vibrates all the jumpers off or out of place.
No, you do not. What are you like hanging out in like the chill corner?
Yeah.
Where nobody can see me.
Yeah.
I'm gonna do the same thing. Woo! Alright. Let's see if Hamad, what's his name? Hey, it's Mark! Yay! I live in Peoria.
Having beer right now. This is
you. What?
This is ridiculous.
Yeah. Why are you? Are you not? Are you actually not sitting there having a beer?
No, they're at the house.
Oh.
Yeah.
Or the gas station, which is not close.
I don't have beer at work anymore.
All right. No link. I'm out. Link for what? What are you talking about? What are we talking about? Sorry for J-Bug's crazy-ass comments. He did recently have a stroke. He's just looking for the help. Well, we're helping him. Watching this instead of doing my essay that was due yesterday. Well, Adam. I think he threw that cat out the window. Oh, no, I don't think so. J-Bug is my fiancé. He fixes iPhones and other Apple products, but this product needs some tender love and car by the best. Sounds like he needs to screw the battery in, honestly. You're getting some kind of a fight going on here. What is this link stuff?
I don't know.
Where did Mark's goatee go? Goatee?
Garbage can.
What the...
went down Bear's gullet.
How long would you sit right there if I just, like, climbed out the window? Like, what would you be like, hey, come back?
I would just go get that board and put the PMIC on with no green stuff.
And then say, yay, it worked. Dry it off real quick with hot air and all the jumpers just left.
What if you did that?
What if? All right, let's see. God damn it. Where's the fucking green stuff? I have been opening a new tube like every 3 days. It's bad, and I must stop. All right, let's slide this back over here. Mark, are you forced to wear that shirt? Yes, it's his prison uniform.
Yep.
Go put on your other shirt.
Got my orange shirt on.
Yeah, you do. We are ordering new t-shirts. We saw the proof. Super excited. Coming soon to a stream near you. Where's the green stuff? The green stuff. Somebody
put it by the black light stuff.
Okay, now let's look and see our beautiful, crispy jumpers. There we go. Now it's the mark string.
I don't like that at all.
There we go. We'll just sit here and watch Mark just go, ugh. God, no. Oh, it's so painful.
Look, that's ready for a chip. You don't need to do anything more there.
You're probably right. Shit, that's what I forgot to order from iPad Rehab Supply, one of the seven things we sell, is green stuff. So, shit, it's coming out the top.
Chrombopolis Michael wants to know if
an
touch connector is missing a pad, can you scrape the copper to it and retrace it with wire, or will that ground it out?
You tell me. Actually, we needed to get shirts that say, you tell me.
Yeah.
That's tell Sunday we need to order a third one called, you tell me. It is the most popular iPad rehab saying of all time.
Oh, you're putting the green stuff on the blue mat?
Not on purpose. It dribbled. Can't control itself.
Why did you squirt out like
I didn't squirt of any of it. It Look at what it's doing.
Oh, wow.
It's
yeah.
Fucking... green jizz.
Seeping.
Yeah, seeping and weeping. All right, let's get a nice little paintbrush. It's going to get on my hand.
Are you going to cover
up? Oh, it did get on my hand. Oh, it's on my thumb.
Are you going to cover up the little like spots that are normally covered between all those grounds?
Yes, I am. No, not those. I draw the line. I mean, I'm not trying to waste time. No, I don't have a problem wasting time. Oh my god. Oh my god.
So are you just gonna like cover everything and dry it and come back and pick it off the spots you don't want it?
Don't forget to wick it. Oh,
this is painful to watch.
Okay, now I wanna just get this dry. You know what I got on one of my toys from China that is coming soon? I got a thing that you put down so it lets you put all your green goo on, and then it's like it kind of like has a little grid for it. It's like the opposite of a stencil. It's hilarious. It's gonna be great. It's gonna be just what this board needed. Getting a little sick.
Oh man.
Here we go, Mark. Ways to make Mark cry. You know, I did order another UV light Guess what I searched for to find it. Dog urine blacklight.
Dog urine.
Yeah, it did. And I was like, oh, look at that. It's an add-on item on Amazon. Sure. Let's try it. Sounds great.
I need to get one of these kind, because I have the flashlight at home,
mm-hmm.
but I always like turn it on and set it on top of the board.
Oh, geez.
And then, like, I remember it when the batteries are dead.
Oh, yeah, geez.
So, like, every time I have to use it, there goes 3 AAA batteries.
Yeah, not cool.
Hassan says, Jessa, I want to come to you for course. Treat me well.
I will try. I'll try to not yell that much. All right, now we have to edit, because that's too much. It's going to
be
too
yelling,
thick.
But there will be shaming.
Yeah, Wednesday is now official shaming day at the course. All right, so let's see. I want to know if it's possible to patch an LCD. Probably not. If a touch connector is missing a pad. Never scrape. Never scrape. Scraping is raping. That includes wicking. All right, so let's see. I'm going to get a paper towel for my hand that's now green. Ah! You know what we need to have? Commercials. Have a commercial right now. All right. It's gotta be really, really thin. This is too thick. It's just gotta be super thin. I should have just painted it literally with a paintbrush. You know what? The edited, like, Chinese guy videos never have, like, paper towels and and crazy shit like that. That wire there is really too thick. It's gonna bother my chip. All right, there we go. Nice and thin. And we are gonna sub this out for a beautiful donor board and see if anybody thinks that we actually did it. All right, so we are going to stick this in the ultrasonic. That would suck. We're gonna stick this in UV and let it cure. Me and Mark are going to take a quick commercial break and be right back. Where's my phone?
It's over there. Getting a text from Lewis. Hey, the roof stopped
leaking. The roof stopped leaking. Great. What if this worked?
It's not going.
Yeah, it is. Why is it?
done yet?
Do they sell booze in the lobby?
Yeah.
That's where Mark went.
I can't believe Mark doesn't have beer in the fridge.
It's a dark day at iPad Rehab. All right.
We lost Mark.
Let's switch. Let's look at this one again. That's a whole bunch of jumpers. There should be a cat in the shop. Like Oreo cat? I don't think so. It is too bad that you can't...
We should get some techno music that we can play.
We should look up what's the free one. All right, let's move this around again. Zoom out. There you go. This was the first rabbit hole we did. All right, how do we fix this? Let's fix this up. Let's all tell Mark that it worked. All right, here we go. There we go. Love these refurb phones that are sold, almost always missing three or four screws and all the foam pads and janky bits and pieces. Nice dead bug. Yes. I fell asleep 30 minutes into the stream. Did she get data from the iPhone 5 with the messed up PMIC? I wish I would have, too. Almost. Any minute now.
Hassan is not going to sleep until he knows how to find problems so he can do jump on.
Jump all the things.
Yeah.
All right. This is probably not done.
No, it's done. Fine.
Is it?
Yeah, it's fine.
Are you sure?
Yep.
I don't know.
100%.
100% bro.
Alright, let's grab it because we ain't got all night. Let's stay here and work on this until morning when the students come back. Alright, so let's see. Let's see what we need to do to get
nothing.
Some of these.
It's ready. Just slap a PMIC on there. The end result's going to be the same either way.
I really should just take a VCC main reading right now.
Yeah, do it.
But I'm not gonna. This little pad is not quite in the right spot. It's going to work, Mark.
Yeah.
What would you do if it booted and then I was like, wow, it booted. Let's go ahead and put on the image, dude.
I would remind you that you'll need something to stream tomorrow.
Oh.
Where did this come from?
That guy in New York City.
The Rossman?
No, not that guy. Not this one. Not this one.
Did it come from Sonny's guy?
I'm sure it looks like it's been to Sonny's guy.
Yeah.
It's been to a bunch of guys. Here's what I want to know. Did you work on this... Are you one of the guys that's already worked on this? Apparently it's been to a whole bunch of people. I wonder who it's going to go to next. We're going to clear the green off of the good pads. So sick over here. So what you need to do, Mark, you've got to be precise. You have to have, like, precision and detail if you want to succeed in this business.
Well, when I'm at home, I apply the green stuff.
You do?
with a hypodermic needle.
From your
tiny bit comes out.
Where do you get that from? The guy that sells drugs?
Yeah.
I need a hypodermic needle.
Yes.
Oh, you need heroin to go with that? No, I'm good.
I could get them off of the Silk Road.
Yeah.
They're all used, so they're cheap.
Well, a little dried blood makes the green stuff just go on that much easier. All right, so let's see. This one, that one. Gotta get in here. Get that one dug out. Look at this, now featuring new NCs that are made of green goo. See, this wouldn't really be that bad if I was working at home and watching something on TV. You could just sit here and, you know, pick around. It wouldn't be annoying.
It would still be a waste of time.
It would still be a waste of time, yes. You know, but it's kind of fun. What?
I just love how you had to cover like a dozen things. So the easier method was to cover like 5 dozen things and then just uncover the other 4 dozen.
Yeah. Yep. That's the easy way. What if I put it back in the ultrasonic and the ultrasonic washed it off all the green stuff?
Tarman wants to know why you didn't just swap the NAND over to another board. Wouldn't that have been easier?
Nope. Not even Mark would have done that. That would not have been easier. If it would have worked, I would have done it. You know what's going to be really funny? When this PMIC has a big ass short, we take it off, and then Mark's like, just let me put one on with no green stuff. I mean, instead of getting like ESD shoes and an ESD floor, we should get some kind of like slippers that everybody has to wear that are like really spongy so that you can walk around without like killing. You're gonna have to stop that. You're like you're going to make... Somebody is throwing up right now, thanks to you. Just too much vertigo. How do you know where to scrape away the green stuff? This green stuff is too thick. What are you doing with that laser? Why do I see like a cat? Nobody can see that.
I know. I can't like put it on you from this angle, and I'm not getting up.
Yeah, gotcha.
Trying to find something reflective up here.
Nothing's working.
Got a bunch of nice shiny pads right here. That would work. If you blind me after all of that eclipse glasses we had to have, if I end up getting blinded by Mark's laser pointer, we're going to have some words.
All right, only 40 more pads to go. We're almost there.
Almost there. It's way too thick up here. I wonder how many of these ground pads are really necessary. Seems excessive.
You know what I actually would have done here?
Thrown this board in the trash and gone to the bar?
No, you take just a little bit of cotton from the cotton swab,
mm-hmm.
ball it up at the end of your tweezers, and then just wipe down all the stuff you don't want to be covered before you cure it.
I thought it would be really easier to pick than this.
No, it's not.
I've never had to pick it before.
Yeah, I've had to rework long screw damage a couple of times, and this stuff fucking sucks.
Did not know.
Yeah, it sucks for rework.
It'd be funny if I pulled another pad doing this.
Danielle Angelini from Italy wants to know why it's full of solder mask. Because Jessa makes poor decisions.
No reason. Because it's pretty. And it's just got to have like a mix, like silver and gold, kind of green and silver, just so pretty.
Because 10% of what's covered actually needed to be.
Yeah, because of that. I probably went down to like 30 pads now.
Oh, Lewis has shown up. He said he's finally done with his run. was that... did you do the late night run behind the UPS trucks?
Did you go chase down some FedEx trucks for fun? Is that what's going on? Hey, look what I'm doing. I'm working on a crazy board. Cray, cray, crazy board. There's a guy that wants to ask you a question, Lewis, about a board. He wants to call you. I think you should post your number here.
Lewis says that board looks like an SMC stencil.
Yeah, this board is this board's seen some better days. It originally had a note on it that's still sitting here. Here's the note. This is my original note. Can you read it?
No.
It says, "Hell no. Nope. Fuck no." That was my original diagnostic. Why am I doing this? I don't know. I don't have a good answer for that. All right, let's pick out this useless jumper. Great. All right, that's all fine. That's enough. close enough.
This is so painful.
So painful. I'm really just doing this to aggravate Mark, which is pretty fun.
You're uncovering the NC pads, too.
I know, I thought it... Well, two of them I didn't because I was sure. They're there. They obviously, they're there for a reason, Mark. It's something to do with the Illuminati. Painful, painful repair. And now,
Lewis,
to uncover my fun jumper.
Lewis wants to know if I'm barred from going home until you finish this. No, Lewis, I was actually intending
he
to...
He already left. He
yeah,
came back
like,
to, like, take a shit or something, and then he
two,
thought this was so engrossingly
ago,
interesting.
I left, but before I got in the car, I found out I had some tickets to reply to, so I came back in, and then Jessa was so sure that this is going to work that, like, I... Just
it's
gonna
work
because I wanted to
laugh.
See, yeah, I wanted to witness the
history making
failure.
The wait, what? The history making save, not horrible. You said the wrong thing. And then we just started chatting about Hatchimals, and now this is happening. So, Lewis, how are you going to ship Oreo to Tarman, or is he going to come pick it up? Pick him up.
Yeah, Tarman will take Oreo off your hands.
Yeah. Problem solved.
No, I'm not popping bubble wrap. That's my water bottle.
Did somebody ask that?
Yeah, is Mark popping bubble wrap in the background?
No, he's got this terrible gum habit. This has a better chance of working than I have a chance of getting a good website from. Wow, so, okay.
No, it really doesn't. It has the same
The same chance. Which is more likely? If you were a bookie, Mark, which is more likely that this is going to work or that guy is going to be able to make a website that doesn't make Lewis want to hang his head in shame?
No, it's even...
Even
odds.
Even odds?
Yeah.
If this doesn't work, does that make Lewis's chance of a website kind of go up? Or that's not how that works.
Tarman wants to know if I accept his $1 bet that this thing will work.
Yeah, Mark. Yeah. Or are you all just hype? Because you know it's going to totally fucking work.
I don't know. How sure are you that it's going to work? You want to...
He said he was 95% sure.
No, he said 75% sure that it's going to work. And then there was another percentage of, like, going to work but have some minor problem. And then 5% that it's not going to work at all. So I'd say if you put a dollar for every percentage that you think it'll work, I'll put a dollar for every percentage I think it'll work.
Say the name, Jessa.
And I'll even up.
I will not. That's your job. I hired an excellent web designer, Chelsea, from Scriptable Solutions. Very excited about what Chelsea's building for us. Highly, highly recommend them. And Lewis can recommend his own guy if he wants to or not. But so what happened? Did he answer? Did you send me anything?
Said he has a really long set of work ahead of him to get to number one on Google for that guy's name.
Yeah. So are we on full violence mode? Like, did you give up? No, diplomacy is over. I think you should give diplomacy like a couple days. Let him stew on it. Little diplomacy before the bus comes to drive over. All right, these ones, I don't remember. You think there's hidden jumpers under there, or are they actually no stuff? 1, 2, 3, 4, number 5 and 6. I gotta check.
Said, I politely told him I would ruin his life if he didn't refund me.
I saw that, but did he answer that? Like, no. All right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I politely told him to ruin his life if he didn't refund me. Liam Neeson in Taken style after he said no refund. I saw the last thing that you wrote, which I thought was still reasonable, mostly because I wrote 90% of it. But what did he answer after that? I think, you know, after he had a chance to kind of, you know, what if I call him up and say, "And hey, Mark, call up this guy and offer him protection, like the mafia. Hey, you got a nice little web design business here. Sure hope something bad doesn't happen to it." He did not answer that one. I'm already building the blog, the articles at the sites I will send. I began editing the video as well. Wait, you already made a video? I want to see. Make it private and send me a link. I want to see. All right. All this work to fail. This will be two monumental failures in a row. Coming up to cap off a fun day of practical board repair school. You know what would be funny, Mark?
What?
If you went around while you're just hanging out and fixed all of the students' devices so that we could just be like, rule number one, goddammit! That would be really funny. Oh, just yeah. So, what are you doing? What the fuck are you doing? I'm scraping away some little solder masks so that my 10-jumper PMIC... Here, let's show Lewis this board. This is what the... I already put back a shit ton of caps. Like, it's got a chip here that has... I'm making this board great again. It's got balls on one side and mashed flat with no balls on the other side. It has just corroded to hell caps absolutely everywhere and that have absolutely no business living on a board. Just an awful, awful mess that nobody's ever even bothered to pluck off. It is... missing off half the pads for this required chip for image. It has shit looking filters everywhere. It's got a big old chunk out of the compass IC. But here's the cake. Here's the big one. Look at that. TriStar has been reflowed. There was a big solder ball right here at one point. A solder ball literally coming out of the CPU.
And somebody, you saw that, and you were like...
I saw that.
I think this is a good candidate for 15 jumpers under the PMIC.
Yeah. So what I'm doing is I'm just trying to diagnose this phone, which meant the raped PMIC, missing all sorts of keys. Oh, there was a solder ball popping out of that, dude. There's still, like, frank corrosion on this board. I mean, this is bad, 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 bad news. But it's going to work. It's going to work. Great. Jessica, give up, go home. No, I will not. This is what, you know what? This is what I was talking about. This is what I'm doing instead of all those other things. This what? I don't get it. There's a disease. All right. This is what I'm doing instead. And meanwhile, there's a whole bunch of quicks back there still in the boxes that nobody's even getting out. I want to take one home and start using it. So you don't like the idea, Mark, to go around and fix all the student boards so that you can just go, guys, rule number one, seriously. You were supposed to diagnose this stuff. Why are you bringing us a bunch of stuff that doesn't have anything wrong with it?
I think the guy with, like, 6 long screw damages is going to notice this.
Well, no, you're going to fill them up with solder on top.
Yeah.
Put your jumpers put green and then fill them up with solder. I just want to know what it was like to be him hearing the day one talk about, like, the quartz crystals, or the, you know, like the 24 megahertz crystal, and him thinking, huh, probably shouldn't have taken that off then, thrown it away. That was, might have been a bad idea. Or is he thinking, do I have the stones to even show this board now that is missing a crystal on purpose? Okay. All right, Mark, do you know, can I scrub this with alcohol, or is it going to wipe off the stuff? Let's find out. I think you can probably scrub it with alcohol. Scrub, scrub. Look at that beautiful PMIC area. So pretty, so great. So amazing. Oh, look, a piece of this coil just decided to shit itself. That's okay. We don't need a housing for the coil. All you have to do is just be a coil. We got a little bridge right here. Bink. Why are pads connected to each other? All right. Again, wouldn't it be easier to swap the SSD onto a Great Again board? No, that doesn't work. We would have done that if that works. It doesn't work. This board hinges on whether or not the CPU is already fucked or not. Oh shit, I forgot to put green on this side. I'm going to have to do it again. I didn't put green right there. God, that's just hilarious. Ah, alright. Why are the pads connected to each other? You're not answering any of these questions. All right, someone stuck that board in a microwave. Oh, I'm sure it's been in a microwave. Looks like it's been to the beach. All right, I don't think I can test it with this chip like that. All right, now we're ready to do a VCC main reading. Are you ready, Mark? We are gonna see whether or not there is a short on VCC main.
Are we though?
Yes.
What about that whole row of green pads there?
Mark, those obviously are not part of the thing, I don't think. Are they?
Yeah, the gap is
just that?
Yeah.
It's not all that?
Nope.
Oh, damn. Well, I'm still going to take a VCC main reading.
Yeah, do that.
Tarman says VCC main is going to be fine. Let's find out. So we're going to start over here with a known good. So that we know, well, this is actually not known good. This is just donor board that I pulled out of the pile. But let's find out, what is the diode mode reading on VCC main? It's 0.145, and that's what I remember. Something, I know it's pretty low for iPhone 5. So 0.145 is what we're going for, and not a full-ass, big-ass short. Survey says 0.146. Yes! Look at that, Mark. Ha! I'm going to make this board great again. So we are on track. This is going to work. Mark, did the chance that this board is going to work just go up?
Nope.
What? So it's still at definitely fucking hell no?
Yeah, no, I didn't think you're going to fail at this because there's a pre-existing VCC main short.
Okay. Are you sure there's only one row here? Not two? It doesn't go two all the way around? All right. Let's check. God damn it. Fuck.
Yeah.
Back to the scraping. Just when I thought that there was a little bit of light there at the end of the tunnel.
Just leave the stream running and then come back.
And what, like, some kids are going to come
in
here and
in
put this
in and finish up.
That
see
would be
if
pretty funny.
Anybody still watching?
Yeah, that would be pretty funny. It would be funny to just kind of have a clip that you could then make be the background of just like scraping, you know, it would be like a 30-minute clip of something like running jumpers and then putting on green stuff and then scraping green stuff away. And then you just kind of
Wow, Tarman has gone up to 95% chance of working.
Wow.
All right, so the odds are now his $95 to my $1.
Wait, I got a percent out of you? You think there's a 1% chance this could work?
I'll give a 1% chance just so that there's, you know...
Some stake in the game?
Yeah.
That's just a pity 1%?
Yeah, that's...
That's just pity?
That's just a I want his money 1%. But he never actually agreed to that, so... So you don't get the one. You only get the 1% if he agrees to pay me $95 if this works. Which he's reiterated that he does not agree to. So his 95% chance is complete bullshit.
That is a lie. That's fake news right there.
If he really thought this was going to work, he would put the money up.
I think that some odds adjustment is in order. I'm going to say that the chance that this is going to work has now gone up to 20%.
Mm.
20%. Instead of 5%, now 20%.
But there wasn't a VCC main short when you were at 5%.
You don't know that. That's what it was. It was my 5% because I thought there was definitely a VCC main short somewhere else.
Oh.
But now that I know that there's not, then obviously this board should have worked a long time ago. Which is pretty unbelievable, given the state of the VCC main. All right, so those ones are definitely supposed to be still. That's really way too thick there. If it doesn't work the first time, I'll just try three or four more PMICs.
Taylor says he just noticed there is no dislikes on this video.
What? I can fix that.
Problem solved.
All right. Okay, hashtag fake Mark. Yeah, look at you. Mark is only talking to some work. Yeah, he's so hard to find good help.
My work day ended after my 12-hour shift.
That's true. Mark's 12-hour shift did end... 3 hours and 21 minutes ago. The odds haven't changed. Only your perception of them from the towel repair.
Exactly.
Hmm. All right.
The odds have been 0% since the board entered the building.
No, since the board came out of the oven and since the guy switched off the Wagner when he pulled away from, when he took away from him, when he goes, now that'll do it. As he backed away from the TriStar repair. Let's see if it works now. Yeah, from that moment. I'd like to meet whoever that was. And punch him in the face. Not to be unkind. But still.
Yeah, I think you should put this PMIC on.
All right, I'm ready to put the PMIC on.
You gonna use the Wagner?
Fuck no! God, no! Not after all that. Although, if it was back at the beginning, I think that would be really tempting. If it was back at the beginning.
I'd put it on with the Wagner with no green stuff.
I am kind of concerned about whether or not it's even a good idea to boot it with this guy. Let me look and see. I got to see if there's shorts on that. All right. And then it's time for PMIC and test. It's going to be the moment of truth.
You don't even need that guy.
I do need that guy because he's got some 1V8s. That's what I'm a little bit worried about here. So his name is U22. I don't know what RF reset L is. RF reset. That doesn't sound important.
Oh, there are three dislikes now.
Oh, PP1V8.
Who else?
And Oreo. PP1V8 and 1V8.
Me and Lewis and Lewis's alternate account.
And Fixin' Mom or whatever it is. What was it?
Tarman says $5.
Well, you got some skin in the game now. All right, so let's go over and measure to see whether or not there is a 1V8 short. That would suck if there was a 1V8 short. All right, I think it's that cap. Let's see. Come on, no 1v8 short. Come on, no whammies. Let's go.
Tarman wants to know if I agree to the $5. I agree that you can put up $5. I will put up $1 to your $5.
So will you actually pay the stamp cost to mail Tarman your $1?
Well, I assumed we were going to do this through PayPal.
Oh, well, okay, fine.
I'm gonna pay for the stamps to send it in pennies.
Here's 100 pennies. It cost me $2 to send you.
I'm not even concerned about that because it's not going to work.
It's going to work great.
Absolutely not.
Going to make this board great again. I'm going to trump this board. Okay. Now, Mark, do you have an iPhone 5 PMIC?
You can
I'm sure it'll find. All right, I happen to have.
I have some brand new ones, huh?
Yeah, new. I don't know about new. Yeah. All right, now let's see. Let's look at this PMIC and let's guess if it came off the floor in Shenzhen or off the counter. Got a couple of hairs in it. It doesn't look too bad.
It's fine, put it on.
Yeah, no, it's going on. All right, now who remembers the orientation? Where's the other board?
Doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter. It's all the same either way.
Yeah, it's like a capacitor.
All right, so the apple leaf is pointing at the NAND. All right, so let's make that match. All right, kids, wake up. Getting ready to get somewhere. All right. Flip him around. The apple leaf goes right up there.
Chris, it's an iPhone 5. It's a raped iPhone 5 that had solder balls coming out.
Stop talking bad about my board. You're going to hurt his feelings. Are we messing with an iPhone 5 or a 5C? This is a 5. Welcome, Chris Long, to the October 48-hour marathon. My rabbit hole's bigger than your rabbit hole. Here, Chris Long, look at my other one. Although this one's going to work great. This one did not work out. There we go. It's a lot of jumpers. Ding. Yeah, so that one's rabbit hole number one. We're on rabbit hole number two. This one is gonna work. This one's gonna work great. If only I can get some tweezers that are big enough. Ooh, yeah, here we go. Good old red guys. That's what I'm talking about. Yeah, it's kind of tough that my janky row of caps up there make it so that I can't see like the line that this thing should be on.
It's fine.
I'm starting to think that Mark doesn't think this is gonna work. I don't know why. All right, now let's compare that alignment because we are gonna have to be real crisp on the alignment here. So it's really tight on the crystal. So it might need to even go over another nudge. Okay. Do 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 do. We are going to heat this up. And watch it just slide off because we've gotten a little nutso at 1:29 a.m.
Yeah.
All right, and now for the finest touch. Jealous people always making fun. Keep going, Jessa. You the best. Thanks. Thanks, Monkeith.
What's on there?
No. Alright. Chris Long has faith.
Yeah, he didn't say he has faith in what, though.
He has faith
like
this is bullshit. This is gonna fucking be a giant waste of time. I don't think anyone disputes that this is a giant waste of time. It is clearly a giant waste of time.
Oh, Tar Man, he disputes that.
Well, I don't think even he disputes that it's a giant waste of time.
Well, if it's successful, it wasn't a waste of time. I mean, aside from, like, doing things unnecessary, like covering half the pads in green stuff.
It's gonna be mighty tough to get this chip on here.
Holy God. I can't watch.
I mean, I hate to tell a chip where to go, but it's kind of hard not to here. I think that's too far over from the crystal.
I think it's perfect.
Do you?
Yeah.
I think it needs some flux now. We need some music. Can you, like, sing?
No, I'm good.
Damn it. No, stop that. I really don't think you should go that far over.
It's fine.
I really don't want you to go that far over. Huh. I'm gonna have to break you off of your one ball. Because I can't have you doing that. Mark's gonna cry.
It's never gonna end.
Mark is gonna cry. Well, maybe it's all right.
It's fine.
I would like to know what part he's like stuck on though. Look at the other one. It's really tight on that diode there. Okay. Alright, that is seems to be how he wants to go.
Yeah, it's good to go.
Alright.
Blast that sucker with some 400 degrees and get
it on there. Alright. It's just the coil. If not, transfer everything to the motherboard. You know, this video is going to end up being nothing but a sea of comments about, why don't you just take the chip off and put it on the board?
I would have given that like a 1%.
Really?
Yeah.
I hate to tell a chip where to go, but this guy's really just misbehaving for a little bit. Fuck that. All right. And now we wait.
Shut that bad boy up. It's ready to go.
Calls next day, error 4013. I spent so much time on a board the other day and got it working only for it to stop the next day. iPhone 5S liquid damage, long screw damage, and NAND error. Got it all fixed and booting. Customer calls the next day, error 4013. God damn it. That's why. Customer would be calling next day to say, thank you so much, Chris, for getting my data. All right, let's shut that thing up. All right, and now let's see if we have a VCC main short. Oh, by the way, Chris Long, this board had solder balls popping out of the CPU and a bunch of heat on TriStar.
Rehab TriStar, bro.
Rehab iPad. Rehab TriStar. It's missing the negative boost IC completely, which is going to be required for image, and. Just got about 10 jumpers under the PMIC. Let's go ahead and let's ditch the fucking compass while we're got some hot air out. Can't have that. See you later, compass. You asshole.
Yeah, so Chris, now what percentage of chance do you give this?
Yeah, Chris, what's your bet? Are you a we're taking percentage. Mark refuses to give this a 1% chance that this is going to work. I'd say 20%. And that is up. That is up from previously 5% when I started out here. All right, this still kind of hot. Gotta put off the bad news of now having a VCC main short so we can't even test. So let's just wait one second. Isn't that pretty? Oh, also, this this chip here is all squashed on one side. And we're going to leave. Tarman says 95% chance that this is going to work. What Tarman's like in Vegas.
Put your money where your mouth is, Tarman.
Okay.
Put a dollar up for every percentage if you really think it's going to work.
All right. Time for our VCC main reading after PMIC is on. I really hope that PMIC is not upside down. Survey says 0.099. Come on, keep coming up. So normal is 0.145.
Oh, you're at 0.100.
0.100. That's close enough, baby. All right. So let's let that cool down, and then we will all go home and just not even bother to test. What's the point? Do we really want a good morning? Uh-oh.
We'll test it tomorrow.
We will
after you swap the board out.
Yeah, so tomorrow's rabbit hole will be when Mark gets this board to do a CPU, NAND, EEPROM, baseband CPU transfer to this other board.
Yeah, that's solid 1% right there.
Solid 1%. All right, let's see. Did we get off of 100?
Yeah,
100. Yeah. Yeah, we did. 106.
Vikash Kumar says, I want to learn. Give me your contact details, please.
Please. Hmm. Alrighty.
Vikash, you can go to Rossman Repair.
You can go to mailin.repair.
Mailin.repair.
Read all about.
That's where you can sign up to learn about board repair.
Look at the balls hanging out the side.
No, that's just
no sides. Yeah, you're looking. You think I can see how it would appear that there are solder balls there, but those are the traces. See that? That's a trace. See how that you can see the brown part there? I don't know if you can see the cursor or not. Like this cap on one side, one trace is still brown, and the other was braided like by an idiot, and so that's why it is now tinned with copper. So it's certainly not any kind of solder balls. The thing I'm concerned about is that guy. Let's make sure these two dudes can talk to each other up here. Let's check on that.
They're fine.
They're fine. They like it like that. There's nothing to worry about there. Yeah, that's all ground. So we don't need to worry about that.
Yeah,
he's
good to go.
Good to go. Let's see. Maybe it's time, Mark.
Come on.
Maybe. Don't worry. Apple will release a patch tomorrow to disable your PMIC swap unauthorized repair. Okay. Still kind of warm.
Yeah, if there's any repair that should be unauthorized, it's this one.
It's this one. Yeah, exactly. Please, bro, don't ever do this at home.
This is
retarded. Come on.
It's one time I'll agree with the Apple support communities.
121.
You're good.
I am probably good. So what I'm doing now is taking a VCC main reading because I want to know, can I tell right now that my PMIC is or bridged or not sitting on balls well? And so I'm checking that by testing VCC main, and here's why. If we go over to ZXW and we find the good old yield PMIC, we click on VCC main. See how VCC main goes all the way around the chip? So if the chip were at an angle or weird or lopsided or nudgy, then look at what it would take to turn to marry VCC main to you know something else. It's all around the edge. Yeah. So therefore, if VCC main measures normal after PMIC replacement, then that is a little bit of a tell for us that the PMIC is not, I mean, it may not be on correctly. It may not be making good contact on every single one of those pads and every single one of those jumpers, and this is probably going to be a big fail. But maybe it is. So a good, healthy VCC main reading at least tells us that we still have a chance. We aren't completely sidelined here. All right, what is it?
123, perfect.
All right, so 123, I'd like it to be 145. So I'm gonna take this chip off. All right, so the board, as the board, you know, kind of continues to cool down, then the resistance will change and it will go up. But it is 143. I definitely want to be in bed at 2. So that means it's time.
Do it.
It's time. It is time to see. And hand camera, it's probably worth it to like hook that up, but that's too many steps. So I'm going to connect
I'm here to make sure she doesn't lie about it.
You can trust me, bro. Yeah. There's no need to put on a screen because we won't have image. So we're just seeing, does the DC power supply say that this thing has a big S short? If you want, Mark, you could make that camera look at that. Ugh. All right, let's move this over. What, just because it's hooked with wires? That's what the big deal is.
Yeah.
All right, and now for the exciting moment of probably neither truth nor failure. It'll be like, well, you know, just do it one more time. All right, here is the iPhone 5 battery connector, which we're going to plug in and see. Hopefully, it stays on 0 amps. It does not. Wow, look at that. All right, so what happens when I plug in? I plug in the battery connector, and I instantly see 170 milliamps of current consumption.
Now, is that normal?
No, that's
not.
No,
it doesn't,
not.
Doesn't usually do that?
No, I don't think so. I don't think it's probably got a little bit of a leak somewhere. That's kind of weird. Probably on battery VCC, because it looks like shit. Let me see if I can find anything that feels kind of hot. I mean, I know it's not the PMIC. This is a gross, really disgusting board, I have to say.
Oh, it keeps, oh God, it's all over the place.
It's probably the connector. Let's switch it out.
Oh yeah, it must be the cable.
It's just the cables, no doubt, duh. Yeah, let's get rid of this juicy swirl. Good times. Negative, positive. Oh, we're missing a. Missing what's going on. Freeze time. Oh, fuck that. All right. Let's see. It's a little power hungry, no biggie.
Don't eat, please.
Don't eat the board, please. Okay. All right, so it's got 180 milliamps.
Well, that's what you want.
Have you tried turning it off and on again?
So I mean, this is going right along with my prediction, is that it was going to initially be a short, and then once you find and clear that short, it's going to be 50 milliamp or lower.
It's getting a little warm on NAND.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, it's not the PMIC at all. It's somewhere around here on NAND.
Did you try to re-hot NAND?
No, I didn't. The initial jump is just because it's refilling its empty electron banks and it has a really constricted nozzle. Yeah, NAND is hot. All right, let's check some NAND power rails then.
Oh my God. This would make a really good, like, Friday night follow-up stream.
I don't ever want to work on this board again. What are you talking about? All right, let's test some voltages. How are we doing on here? All right, so our main voltage is 3.9. All right, where can we measure 1V8?
On a cap that's on 1V8.
You know any?
Yeah.
I think I had to find one before by cumulus. All right, let's see. Let's see what's going on here. You know, 3VO TriStar and 3VO NAND are probably on the same thing. All right, so 1V8 is 0.7, so that's our problem. All right, the good news is that that's kind of suspicious for our little piece of shit dude that we're already worried about. All right, let's actually do diode mode on 1V8.
What is 1V8 supposed to be on a 5?
I think 0.3. All right, so it is 0.3, but you know how 1V8 is. Crazy and janky. I think I already checked around these guys. All right, those are all fine. But I wasn't getting... I'm pretty sure you're supposed to get 1.8 volts.
What, on 1V8?
Oh, look at that. Compass is hanging out right there. Get out of here. Get out of here, you asshole. All right, let's see if... I really don't have a whole lot of patience, and I kind of do feel like prompting to boot anyway. I wonder if those could be touching ground. I don't think they could even be touching ground. I think that chip's just not working. Okay. Let's see what happens. All right, so we have 180 milliamp short. Something is short. Let's actually check battery, which I did not check before. Check a little battery. 0.3, that's low, isn't it? 0.3?
Let's see. 0.3 for what, battery?
Yeah.
I don't know. Five.
I don't know on a five either. Where's my five? 0.3. Let's see. That'd be a great one to be low. Damn, 0.377. 0.366. Alright, so not battery. Something's leaky. Out of my PMIC. Maybe it's something that we don't really need. I think it's going to not respond to prompt to boot at all, but let's see. All right, let's prompt to boot. Mark probably has a sweet race car bed of his own. All right, let's prompt it to boot. Prompt to boot, and it doesn't respond at all via USB. Let's go down the power button connector, and it doesn't. I forget which one of these is. This one or that one? That one or that one? And where is it getting? Where's your receipt tape? Definitely getting hot on NAND. We gotta look up where the NAND power rails are. You know what this is gonna be, don't you? 1VM, 1CPU short. Let's find out. Voltage. All right. What am I forgetting in here? Let's see. Oh, yeah. These guys. You, I think, are supposed to be 1V1. Hey, I got my 1V1. That's working. Jess, I ordered iPad 3 PMIC from China the other day. $30 a piece. I expected a Rebald IC to arrive. They come in still with complete coverage in underfill and old solder from the pool. Wow. iPad 3 PMIC. I'll sell you one for $25 and it'll still be on the board. Take it off yourself. all right. Okay, so we got some heat around here, around the old NAND. Honestly, it kind of feels like it's coming from around our TriStar area. I'm gonna say the likelihood is probably TriStar itself. It does not respond to USB at all. So I think next.
What? You think that the underfilled chip with solder balls popping out all around it could be the source of the problem?
Yeah, I do. I'd be willing to bet 9 cents on it. Yeah, honestly, I think that PMIC is fine. And it's producing some voltages. We just found that it is producing one of the most commonly not produced voltages, which is the 1V1, it is a couple of iPhone 5s I couldn't make the PMIC make 1v1, but this is making 1v1. And I think that we need to next turn our attention to the sort of the next big problem on this board now that PMIC is back, which is dealing with the fact that TriStar was heated. It's got all these solder balls popping out of it. So I'm not gonna call this one dead yet. So PMIC part is done. And we're gonna have to put it as time for phase two, which we're not gonna do today. So it's gonna be, chapter two, coming back to the Hell No board. To see what happens if we take off and actually try to change out that TriStar chip. So, so far, so good, honestly, I think. What do you think?
I think it's going exactly as I expected.
All right, so it's time for us to go to bed. And our point with this stream is whenever you're feeling like, man, nothing's working and there's rabbit holes all around me, you know, there's rabbit holes for everybody, and always remember, my rabbit holes are bigger than your rabbit holes. We'll see you next time.